Detroit to win and stay in playoff contention, Eric Money, a 6-foot backcourt player, has to keep the Pistons' fast break cracking as the pressure is really on now. And Marcus Johnson has been at his best as the young Milwaukee Bucks are in a battle to hold to a final playoff spot in the West. As today, the Bucks meet up with the Detroit Pistons in the NBA on CBS.
The NBA on CBS. Today's game is sponsored by the Miller Brewing Company, brewers of Miller High Life. If you've got the time, we've got the beer. All the new 1978 Chevrolets now at your Chevy dealers everywhere. And by Lanier Business Products, dictation equipment to help you get more done.
This is the Mecca in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. The building is sold out as the Bucks, holding to the final playoff spot in the West at the moment with 8 games to go, really have the heat on them now. They've lost Marcus Johnson. At least he'll not start this game. We wish all of you a very happy Easter. I'm Don Cricky with John McLaughlin. And John, how does it look to you today? They've both got to win it.
Well, they certainly do. This will be a game with playoff intensity. Detroit needs every game just to stay alive for that playoff race, that sixth position. Milwaukee in it right now. They need every win just to stay in front of Golden State, Chicago, and Detroit, as you can see here.
Well, Detroit is still in it, although the numbers are working very much against the Pistons. They are coming off a victory over Portland, however. Marcus Johnson injured his left shoulder against the Philadelphia 76ers and Daryl Dawkins on Friday night. And I guess he's a doubtful performer today, which could hurt.
Well, Marcus says he wants to play. He planned on starting, but apparently the coaches decided to hold him back and see how he felt.
Johnson is the rookie out of UCLA, one of 3 number 1 draft choices on the Milwaukee Buck roster, and he has been superb so far this season. Alex English is going to start in his place, as the officials today are Earl Strom, and out there with him is, looks like
Hugh Evans.
Hugh Evans is the other official. All right, so we're set to go, and there's the Detroit starting lineup with Bob Lanier. As you know, out of the lineup now, underwent knee surgery on Friday. It was a success, but he'll not play again this season. We'll be talking briefly with Bob Lanier at halftime. Leon Douglas, the second-year center from Alabama, starts in his stead, as Ginelli will jump for the Milwaukee Bucks there in the white uniforms. Tip is controlled by Leon Douglas. He gets the ball over to Shoemate, and we're underway. Back to Eric Money. Douglas playing down low. Ginelli against him now as they set men up to the left side, away from the ball. Now Price, quarterbacking guard, fires on Brian Winters. Can't get the roll. The ball is tipped over to Dave Myers. And Quinn Buckner, the big, powerful guard out of Indiana, brings the ball up court for Milwaukee. Here's their top scorer, Brian Winters, looping it down low. Nicely done to Dave Myers.
Very nice set play. The Milwaukee Bucks trying to run a pick and roll here. The Pistons, they will want to run, but if they don't have a straight out break, they'll want to try to control the game as much as possible.
ML Carr pulls up. Alex English has the defense there. English called on to start for Marcus Johnson, who is in uniform and who might be in the game. They have ice on his shoulder now on the bench. He underwent diathermy treatment prior to the game. Here is ML Carr. Can't get him. Detroit working hard, getting the second and third shot, but they can't get it down. And Milwaukee, with a 2-0 lead, comes back up the floor. Buckner, who played for a national championship team in Indiana. And Myers with the ball now, former UCLA All-American, national championship team there, and Myers can't get it up, but Ginelli, good position.
Well, the Bucks are aware of going to the offensive boards. They haven't done it very well as of late. Today, they want to concentrate on that, especially with the Pistons. They have a pretty big team, even with Lanier out.
Now, John Shoemate hits from the outside and puts the first points of the game up for the Pistons. As Milwaukee comes into the game with a record of 39-35, 4 games behind Denver in the Midwest Division, but only 1 game up in the loss column on Golden State, as Golden State won again last night, beat the Knicks 133-123.
Brian Winters missing that shot. With Marcus Johnson questionable for today, it's important to the Bucks that Brian Winters have a very fine offensive day.
Eric Money on the clear side, working one-on-one against Quinn Buckner. But Buckner staying right with him. Winters comes over to double up on the ball, and Quinn Buckner gets it and bangs it off the leg of Eric Money. And the ball comes inbounds to the Milwaukee Bucks. John?
The Bucks double-teaming Eric Money in that situation. They feel they must key on him. He's really the heart and soul of this Detroit Piston team now. He can penetrate. He can get a shot pretty much when he wants, so they will double-team him at times.
In addition to the Golden State win over New York, Phoenix beat Buffalo 112-106. San Antonio over Kansas City 132-130. Washington 98, Atlanta 95. Here's the lead to Money. Buckner tips it away, and it's ruled last touch by Eric Money. So again, the Milwaukee Bucks get the ball inbound as they lead 4-2 with 9:56 to play.
Two excellent defensive plays, one by Jimmy Price, the other by Quinn Buckner. And those two players, you have outstanding defensive men.
Winters looks out high to Ginelli. Milwaukee is not a good bumping team. They're not a real physical club, and that's what Detroit feels they have to do, play a rough game inside and take position. Leon Douglas down with the rebound, and now Detroit comes up court looking to tie it up. Jim Price, veteran backcourt player, can't get it through. Shumate firing long again, but he's well short on that. This time it was just by Milwaukee, and Detroit puts the ball in play.
The Bucks would like Detroit to take shots like that all day. They want to push Detroit outside into the jump shot, not allow them inside with their strength.
Here is Quinn Buckner getting the loose ball, leading the break. It's a 4-on-3 break, and Buckner takes it the distance, but he didn't have enough on the shot, as you see now. Dave Myers gets it back the other way, but loses it to the sixth man, the sideline.
You see the Pistons wanting to come out of there, and the Bucks aware of that. Actually, Coach Don Nelson of the Bucks says, I hope they do try to run with us.
Yeah, he'd like to get a track meet going.
Right.
They like to go. Milwaukee, a good young team with a lot of speed, a lot of young legs. Shumate posting Ginelli down low. Ginelli with a height advantage, but Shumate muscles his way in. Now Leon Douglas working hard. Outlet from Ginelli to Winters, and what do we have? Technical foul, Hugh Evans. Signals a technical foul.
On John Shumate, he was a little upset. He thought he was fouled underneath, so he let the official know it right away. And Hugh Evans says, no, John, you can't yell at me like that. It's going to cost.
Yep, it'll cost. So Brian Winters, who's an 80% free throw shooter, goes to the line now for Milwaukee. 84% free throw shooter. Winters comes in averaging just over 20 points a game.
There you go. Well, the post up we just missed, the ball went back up after an offensive rebound by Douglas. The Bucks get it out, and it happened just before we got the replay there. It was a one-on-one situation underneath for John Shumate.
We have 8:55 left to play in the first quarter. As Milwaukee leads Detroit 5-2. Brian Winters gets the ball now over to Alex English. Myers looping it down low. Milwaukee working plays and getting inside shots. And nicely done off the defensive board by ML Carr. Here come the Pistons. By Jim Price, so it cost Detroit possession.
Actually, Jim Price picked up by Detroit just about a month ago or so. I'm not really, don't recall the time exactly, but he's helped this club quite a bit. They feel that he gives them a lot of stability defensively.
Ginelli down low to Buckner. He jumps over Eric Money. Buckner's 6'2". Money's only 6 feet, so he posts him down low and puts the bucket up. It's 7-2 now. Milwaukee with a 5-point lead.
Left strong, Lee.
A lot of muscle inside. Leon Douglas, though, is called for the charge as Dave Myers hit the deck without a lot of help.
Well, Myers does that very nicely. He'll take the charge in there, and he must play that way. He doesn't have a lot of strength, but for a guy his size, he has tremendous quickness. You can see him take the charge there. Douglas had good position.
Alex English, a big live forward from South Carolina, takes it to the basket. Foul call on Alex English. And that foul came prior to the shot, so there's no basket.
Big Leon Douglas taking that charge. That's a lot of guy to take a charge and fall down. It's usually the little guys do that, Don.
They all do it. There's Leon Douglas getting all of it.
Well, that's one of about three things the Pistons want to do. That's a very simple pick and roll, the most basic play in basketball, and Money and Douglas executed it very well.
Leon Douglas. Now in his second year, he was the fourth pick overall a couple of years ago in the NBA draft out of Alabama. 6'10", 230 pounds. Here's another foul call. This one goes against Quinn Buckner, and the ball is back over to Detroit, John.
The Bucks trying to execute their half-court offense that time, and that calls for a play for Buckner to go from left to right, make a pick-and-roll situation. The Pistons played it very nicely. They did not switch.
Shoemate looking down low as Ginelli plays off. He's going to give him that long outside shot. Doesn't let him go into the basket. ML Carr with a good move to the basket, and Shoemate with the offensive rebound. Detroit working hard. Bob Kaufman, the Detroit coach, up calling out signals as his team now has closed to within one. 7-6 as Winters takes it through.
Well, that is a very difficult shot going toward the basket. You have to go to the glass on it, but Brian Winters does it so very well. He has tremendous ball and body control.
Milwaukee is doubling up on the ball a lot. They're really playing the basketball. Money can't get it, but again, Detroit gets the offense. Douglas loses the ball to Dave Myers, and ML Carr takes it away. And ML said, I got it, I'll take it.
Well, beautiful anticipation by ML Carr. He's a very fine player. I really like him offensively and defensively. He plays the game very nicely.
Works hard.
He does, all the time.
So now it is a 9-8 game. Milwaukee again with a one-point lead as English pulls up. All-American in South Carolina, a very lithe, fluid player. Got a big job today as he has to fill in for Marcus Johnson. Buckner gets the ball. Eric Money trying to get it back. The lead goes to Winters. He can fire off the run.
Well, the Bucks are at their best when they get out and run, and you saw Quinn Buckner execute the break very nicely. Winters smartly goes to the left corner, and he can put it in when he's open.
Don Nelson, the Bucks coach, 11 years of Celtics, says we'll run as often as we can because I believe in it after all those years with the running teams at Boston.
How about with Eric Money?
Now we have another foul called. And Shoemate is called for it. We're going to have a pause in the action with 6:05 to play in the first period. It's 13-8 Milwaukee.
People joke about businessmen spending a lot of time on the golf course. Well, I'm a golfer who spends a lot of time on business. When I'm traveling, here's how I keep ahead of the paperwork. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary. I can dictate letters, memos, wherever I am. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary helps get the work done faster, which leaves more time for what I really like to do. Look for Lanier in the yellow pages under dictating machines.
Coming or going on a business trip, you've got no time to waste. And nobody knows that better than Hertz. Whether it's picking up or dropping off your Ford or other fine car, nobody has more to do it faster.
Go, go, Jane, go!
Getting you in, getting you out with super speed.
Go, go, Jane,
Hertz, the superstar in rent-a-car. Hertz, the superstar in rent-a-car.
You know it.
Guilty.
Not guilty. 6 votes guilty, 6 votes not guilty.
Molly, Jim.
This could go on all day. Bailiff!
Pass out the Right Guard deodorant.
Good.
We got stick or spray. With Right Guard, stick or spray protects all day. They don't just cover up odor, they help stop odor before it starts. All day. 6 took stick, 6 took spray. It's unanimous.
Right Guard deodorant. Don't get dressed without it.
Following the game, CBS Sports presents the Sea Pines Heritage Classic. That's Following the Game on most of these stations.
With John McLaughlin, this is Don Crickey back at the Mecca in Milwaukee. And this Easter Sunday, it is the Bucks holding to the sixth and final playoff spot in the Western Conference of the NBA against the Detroit Pistons, a club that is still in it, although the numbers are certainly against them. They really can't afford to lose another one.
None of them can at this point, Don. And every game from this point on, and most clubs have between 7 and 9 games remaining. As you look at Don Nelson, Bucks coach, every game is very important. And they're going to have to go all out all the time.
Nelson says it's tight now, but it will get tighter as we come down the stretch. Quinn Buckner again trying to pump over Eric Money. You'll recall he was successful before. This time, Money takes him on the arm to stop the shot wisely.
The Bucks obviously trying to go at Money as much as possible. As we mentioned in the outset, he's very important to this Detroit team. Therefore, the Bucks want to go at him offensively also. They've tried to post him twice.
Buckner, not a very effective foul shooter. He's only a 64% shooter, averaging just over 9 points a game.
Red's up.
That's better.
Now Milwaukee pressures the ball as they lead the game by their biggest margin, 14-8, with 5:45 to go in the first period. Brian Winters on the outside against Jim Price. He's using up a lot of shot clock, just working the ball over the timeline.
Help!
ML Carr takes it into the lane, and ML Carr pulling up from about 7 feet out.
That's a little too easy for the Bucks. They really want to push them to the side, and they let ML Carr get into the middle that time.
Carr now has four. And Milwaukee's lead is down to four. Ginelli off target. Lots of guys going for the ball. Jim Price, look for this Buck. He's got a set of hands.
He has tremendous nose for the basketball. There they have a mismatch, and the Bucks read it very nicely.
Leon Douglas rejects Dave Myers, and Earl Strom right there says it's clean. Eric Money pulls up off the run, and now Detroit gets right back in it. Down court they go to Dave Myers. No foul call as it's intercepted by Price.
Turnovers by the Bucks. Now Detroit coming back. Eric Money is so good on the break. He gets inside and gets shots in deep on the big guys.
Well, Bob Kaufman says he's so fast they can actually fast break when it's one on two. He can take it down against an overman.
He just scores two straight, and that's what he's so very good at. I think the Milwaukee Bucks might want timeout here.
So Detroit runs off six quick points and ties the game at 14. Detroit playing a very hard, aggressive game, gets right back in it and locks it up with 4:39 left to play in the first period. It is Milwaukee 14 and Detroit 14.
These 1,700 1-gallon gas cans reach up to the highest suspension bridge in the world, demonstrating just one advantage of the new Chevy Chevette.
If the car you drive now has an average EPA combined city highway mileage estimate of 17 miles to a gallon of gas, and you switch to a Chevy Chevette with its higher mileage, you might save up to this much gas, as much as 1,700 gallons over 5 years of normal driving. 1,700 gallons, enough to reach from the bottom of Royal Gorge to the bridge above and then some.
You work the docks. The ships are too big, the loads are too heavy, and the days are too long. But every day you do it, and another ship with a full belly heads out to sea. And you head in for Miller time. Time to relax with the best tasting beer you can find. Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
For a strong America.
Today, ships like this are opening vast areas of the ocean for oil exploration. This one's under contract to Exxon, and she's an engineering marvel. Her electronic positioning systems and other special drilling equipment allow us to reach down into waters as deep as 4,000 feet to search for oil. This ship provides Exxon with valuable deep water experience that will help us find more energy for a strong America.
People joke about businessmen spending a lot of time on the golf course. Well, I'm a golfer who spends a lot of time on business. When I'm traveling, here's how I keep ahead of the paperwork. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary. I can dictate letters, memos, wherever I am. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary helps get the work done faster, which leaves more time for what I really like to do. Look for Lanier in the yellow pages under dictating machines.
We are all tied up at 14 here at the Mecca in Milwaukee. First period, 4:37 left to play in it. As Quinn Buckner, there's a game going on in Philadelphia. Those two NBA Championship Series combatants from last May matched up. Philly holding a one-point lead. We'll be going there for live reports as the afternoon wears on. Buckner in another game in Cleveland, you'll also be seeing updated. The Cavaliers in need of a win every time out to get in the playoffs. Alex English, who is indeed a glider.
He has an excellent touch within the 15-foot area. That's why he's shooting 53% from the field.
And he has two today, both on that similar jump shot from the side, kind of cruising to the basket. Jim Price gets a free one, but it's a long ways. And Alex English sweeps off the defensive rebound, looks for the outlet.
44B.
Buckner is matched up with Jim Price. Brian Winters at 6'4 is going against 6 foot Eric Money. So Winters takes it down low as Myers fires from the outside. Shoemate blocking out nicely, gets the rebound on the one hop, and here comes ML Carr, 6 feet off to Eric Money. And Detroit ties the game again at 16.
Well, Detroit getting a break out of a situation where they really shouldn't have. The Bucks must convert a little bit better, and that's a problem they've had all year, converting from offense to defense.
And 6 points now for Money.
Money can put them up very fast. He can score a lot of points in a short amount of time. And you see Alex English, once again, he gets the ball inside like that, he's tough.
So the man who had to step in for the injured Marcus Johnson, Alex English, has now put up three first period field goals. He has been the difference as Milwaukee holds to a 2-point lead. Shumate fires well off target. Rebound, little money at 6 feet. Sneaking through the big guys and coming away with the ball. Good defense by Ginelli. It was last touched by John Ginelli, and inbounds it will come to Detroit.
There you get a good look at the Milwaukee Bucks defense. They're really pushing baseline, trying to give a lot of help weak side, and they did it very nicely on money as Kent Benson gets set to come in for Dave Myers. The Bucks going with their jumbo lineup of two centers, Ginelli and Benson.
2:59 to play in the first period. Milwaukee 18, Detroit 16. Eric Money spinning off one-on-one against Buckner as Benson is in the game now, the big All-American from Indiana.
Boy, Eric Money's amazing. He can go one-on-one. They clear the side out, and he gets a shot as easily and as effectively as anyone. Nice play by the Bucks.
Milwaukee works the play. They picked off the defense, and sneaking right down uncontested for the shot was Quinn Buckner, who now has scored five. And again, Milwaukee leads by two, 20-18. Eric Money has eight of Detroit's now 20 points as ML Carr drills it.
Well, he can't play any better defense than that. He just put in a tough shot. He's a nice player.
A real nice one. A lot of youth out there. A lot of speed. They can keep this intensity up.
Here we have a play from Benson to Buckner. Buckner gets a layup going right down the middle. The Pistons did not react. A
couple of former Indiana Hoosiers team up. And now Alex English picks up his second foul as it comes back the other way. He was pushing, but Milwaukee gets the ball on Benson's rebound. We're down to 2 minutes to go in the first period. Brian Winters coming off the pick set by big Kent Benson. Winters with a great wrist cut.
He's got a lot in that bag when it comes to offense, and he can shoot off that wrong foot. Just excellent.
Eric Money staying right with it. That was Jim Price coming in. And ruled it was last touched by Alex English, so Detroit maintains possession of the ball.
You know, with this Detroit lineup that they have in there right now, they should have a very fine defensive team. I think it depends on how much work Shumate puts into his defense, but they have some good defensive players.
The ball is put up by Jim Price. Karam's out of bounds, and again, Detroit will put it in play. Hugh Evans, the official, is right on top of it.
Ernie Grunfeld in for Alex English. Don Nelson going to his bench right away. Grunfeld's played some good basketball for the Bucks this year.
Price takes a look. Ball is tipped away from Leon Douglas. Winners, an NBA All-Star the past two seasons. ML Carr pulls up and fires a tough shot. Can't get it to go. Here comes Buckner, looks for the outlet and finds Winters. Detroit makes the transition nicely, gets four men back on defense. And Quinn Buckner gets a hop from a friendly rim.
The lucky bounce, that certainly helps. The Bucks in that situation finding the trailer, Buckner coming up as a trailer, and they do it well.
Eric Money pivoting and weaving inside, looking for the shadows, call for a traveling violation. And so the ball turns over to Milwaukee.
That particular time, Brian Winters came over to double team, and Don Nelson got up to applaud. That's what they want when Money gets the ball.
You can't let him get it inside.
No, he's tough.
Now Ernie Grunfeld, the big rookie, another Bucks number one draft choice out of Tennessee, is in the game. Big power forward. He's at the moment working over behind Benson. Jim Price coming up with the ball, lead to ML Carr. Grunfeld defends as ML Carr with good body can ball control, takes it the distance, and it's now 24-22 Milwaukee. Winners looking for Grunfeld to cut. Let's see who gets it inbounds. It's going to be Milwaukee's ball. It was last touched by Carr. Nope, going to go the other way. So it goes back over to the Pistons, and they can tie the game again at 24 now. They trail by two with 25 seconds to play in the first period. 12 seconds now on the shot clock. Leon Douglas, who can get way up, shoots over Ginelli. And John Ginelli is called for the foul, and Douglas will shoot twice.
That's a very simple play. The Pistons execute very nicely. And it's the big men screening for one another, and they try to post up inside. The Bucks switching on it, but you have to play on the top side and not allow the pass to get in. A guy like Douglas or Shumate, get it in that deep, they're going to get something out of it.
Leon Douglas puts up the first free throw, can't get it to work. Douglas comes into the game averaging 11.6 a game. You see just under 63% as a free throw shooter. A lot of games won at that free throw line just on percentages.
A lot of players don't shoot very well from there either, and there's really no excuse for that. It's just a matter of working at it and shooting them a lot. feeling comfortable with it.
Quinn Buckner is going to let that clock wind down. He's watching it. 7 seconds on the first period clock. Ernie Grunfeld with 4 seconds takes it to the basket. Let's see. All right, we have a zone defense warning against the Detroit Pistons. If Earl Strom should call zone against Detroit again, it's a technical foul.
Actually, I think that call hurt the Bucks in that particular situation.
Yeah.
Ernie Grunfeld had money
step.
Going one-on-one and a lot of size difference.
He had a step, there's no question. They go right back to Grunfeld. Benson hooks at the buzzer and does not get it to go. Yeah, there's no question. Grunfeld had a step and was taken to the basket. So the first period comes to an end. It's a tight one as Milwaukee holds to a one-point lead over Detroit, 24-23. We'll be back in a moment.
Okay, big green tea. If National's going to be the best car rental company, we have got to hustle. Schultz, the last reservation call.
9 seconds, sir.
Walsh, green light service means?
Fast service, sir.
Willoughby, before we rent this new Chevy,
we check all 10 items on the maintenance checklist.
And then?
We sign it, sir.
Okay, team, let's go.
10,000 people working for you, the big green team.
Willoughby.
We're National Car.
Oh, no, he's home.
A kiss goodbye?
You must go. And besides, your beard, it's rough.
Then I'll shave.
There's no time.
I use his Rise with 3 softeners. Rise will start to soak and soften my whiskers in no time. See? Rise helps me get a close shave quick.
You're smooth, Idiot. So quick. Father, how about a close shave?
Rise for a quick close shave.
Control is very important in the game of basketball. And control is vital in the game of life, especially when you're dealing with high blood pressure. Right now, I'm having my blood pressure checked. That's the only way to tell if it's high. If it is high, I'll follow my doctor's advice to control it.
It's normal, Tom.
Good. For more information, ask your American Heart Association. I'm Tom Borwinkel. Remember, we're fighting for your life.
An announcement from the American Heart Association in cooperation with the NBA.
Here we are back at the Mecca in Milwaukee. Ready now for the start of the second period. Bob Kaufman and his assistant Larry Jones counseling the Detroit Pistons as they are without their great center Bob Lanier for the remainder of the season. Lanier having 2 bone fragments removed from his knee. And the operation was termed a complete success, but Bob Lanier won't play basketball again for Detroit until next season, although he'll be ready to go start working out very shortly. He'll be going into rehabilitation exercises.
And that leaves Leon Douglas with literally some very large shoes to fill. Today, so far, he's doing it very nicely.
Douglas has tremendous ability, can really run for a big guy. Now, as we start the second period, we see that Junior Bridgman has come in the game for the Milwaukee Bucks, along with Quinn Buckner, who's been quarterbacking the team. Money's against him.
Side.
Grunfeld in, along with Benson and Ginelli. 2 pivot men now in there for Milwaukee.
Bucks trying to go with a little bit more size, but if they're going to do that, they must go to the boards.
Bucks have led by as many as 6 points. And then Detroit got the turnovers going their way and got the shots going. There's a good feed. Grunfeld goes off to Benson. We'd like to welcome our Philadelphia viewers. This is Don Cricky with John McLaughlin, the Mecca in Milwaukee. The Milwaukee Bucks rolled up a 6-point advantage early in the first quarter. Then Detroit came back with a running game. And now it's a 3-point game. Milwaukee 26, Detroit in red 23. There is Eric Money, who had 8 first-period points, trying to go to the basket. And we have another foul. It's been a rough game.
Well, that was a situation where Eric Money put the ball up. Chris Ford handles the ball a little bit more now that he's in the game. And he made the play over to Eric Money, who then went after his shot, and he'd been better off to just stay out of there.
Every one of Milwaukee's remaining 8 games of vital importance as the Bucks are holding to a 1-game lead in the bid for the final playoff spot in the West. So now, Bridgman comes off the bench, hits his first field goal, and it's a 5-point lead for Milwaukee, 28-23, with 10:56 to play in the first half. Eric Money now has come up with 10 points for Detroit. He's keeping them in the match. It's 28-25.
The Bucks really can't afford to leave him open like they did in that particular situation on the baseline.
Grunfeld, power forward, pulls his way into the lane, but can't get the shot to go. And now Money brings it down quickly the other way as Leon Douglas tries to turn the corner. shut off by Grunfeld. Bridgman sweeps down the defensive board, and Milwaukee's going to keep the tempo up. Ernie Grunfeld a little bit too much on it. Shumate, now the rebound, kicks it out to Chris Ford, who's in the game. As Ford takes a look inside and goes to Eric Money. Al Eberhard also in the game as Detroit's got a running team in there.
Chris Ford, he shoots that little set shot very nicely. Some days he does, it doesn't go down as much as he would like, and other times he never misses it. He's hurt the Bucks some.
Here is a traveling call signaled against the Milwaukee Bucks, and so the ball turns over to Detroit as, again, the Pistons are down by just one, and they can take the lead when we come back. First, we're going to have a timeout on the floor with 9:59 to play in the first half, as Eric Money with 10 points has kept Detroit right in the game.
You're the Pepsi generation.
I never won anything before.
Man, this is always the first time.
Come and have a Pepsi day.
Fixing up your house, Bozo, with tough paint this time. Right, Dad?
Lucite's plenty tough. It resists peeling and cracking.
How come?
For one thing, it's got mica.
Mica?
Mm-hmm. Mica's a mineral that reinforces the paint by forming overlapping plates to help make a tough seal. So it resists peeling and cracking.
He means Lucite lasts.
Now get a dollar refund from DuPont on every gallon of tough sealing Lucite.
See what's new today.
Last spring, 227 specially equipped Chevy Nova police cars were delivered to the Jacksonville, Florida Sheriff's Department. Now, that's a tall order, but no surprise, because law enforcement agencies in 47 states have made Chevy Nova America's best-selling police compact. Now, a lot of the things the police look for in a new car are the same things you'd look for in a new car. Reliability, performance, and value. Chevy Nova, a wanted car, now more than ever.
Next Saturday at 4 p.m. Eastern, CBS Sports Spectacular presents live the East-West College All-Star Classic from Las Vegas. That's next Saturday at 4 p.m. Eastern on the CBS Sports Spectacular.
Now for a report on the Portland-Philadelphia game, let's go to Brent Musburger and Keith Erickson in Philadelphia.
Welcome those of you who have been watching Detroit Milwaukee. We have got a surprise brewing, but it's early in Philadelphia with Willie Norwood of the champion Portland Trail Blazers hitting that free throw to put the injury-riddled Blazers up. That's the score of the game that you're watching. Very tight. Bucks battling for that last playoff spot, hoping to stay ahead. Now it is the 76ers in white. Dawkins moving to the glass, chance for a three-point play, and guess who he came in on? Dale Schluter drew the foul.
Let's watch Daryl Dawkins when he first gets the ball out here. Look at him knock Dale Schluter off of him right there. Now he comes around and takes the ball to the basket. Not much contact right there. I think Joe Gishu missed the first foul. I think Daryl really knocked Schluter off of him.
Harry Glickman called Dale Schluter on Thursday night. Schluter arrived in Detroit 15 minutes prior to their game against the Pistons, took three warm-up shots, came in and played 11 minutes. He's been playing in the City League in Portland. He has the ball right now. He went to Norwood, and here's Schwartzen. Five of the world champions are not here today. Lead pass McLean by the 76ers. Pretty play by Ted McLean. 9:04 left in the first half. Blazers are ahead of the Sixers, 32-31.
29. We welcome you back to Milwaukee as the Bucks, their lead now cut to 1 point again. It's 30-29. This is Don Cricky with John McLaughlin as Junior Bridgman has the ball and gets it to Ginelli. Chris Ford just hitting on a driving shot for Detroit, brings them back to within one. And now whistles, stop play again. We're going to have a foul call, John.
Foul on Eric Money for blocking in that particular situation. That's going to get him out of the game and Jim Price in. That's probably good for the Bucks. And while we were away, the Bucks, they were called for a zone warning also, so you can see the official officials keying on that very much. Both clubs have had their warning.
We have 8:31 left to play in the first half. Milwaukee has Winters and Buckner with 7 points each. English has 6. Bridgman has 4. Money has 10 for Detroit. ML Carr has 8. Shoemate and Ford with 4 each. Down low they go to Benson against Leon Douglas. Quick lead pass goes into Grunfeld, who was hit hard by Eberhard, but Ernie Grunfeld will go to the free throw line to shoot twice.
Personal foul,
Al Eberhard from Missouri.
You see the pass go over to Benson. Now watch Grunfeld come from the weak side, just move under. Eberhard looked the wrong way, couldn't keep his eye on Ernie, and Ernie gets the play, gets the foul.
Green Bay Packers.
He's got some wheels on him, doesn't he?
Get his foot together.
He's a smart player. He's having a tough time today so far, but he's in constant motion. He's an excellent defensive player.
And now it is a 32-29 game on the free throws by Grunfeld. Milwaukee has a three-point advantage. Eberhard takes a look inside, guns it across to Leon Douglas, and people collide in the lane. We had a collision.
Way to go, Lee.
Ginelli is called for the foul.
It's interesting, the philosophies of these two teams defensively. They both really pretty much want to do the same thing. Force everyone to the sideline, press the forwards out as far as you can, and we have a foul on Junior Bridgman.
Early in the second period, Washington's leading the New Jersey Nets 46-41. Cleveland leading Chicago 21-17 in the first quarter. And here at Milwaukee, it's 32-29. The Milwaukee Bucks holding the lead, and there is Dave Myers back in the game. A 6'8 forward, third year. Milwaukee's really built with youth, John. It's, of course, your old club, and you got to like the winner. Here's Lloyd Walton with a steal, challenging Shoemate, and Lloyd Walton loses the defense with a switch hands in midair, and Walton puts it down, and Milwaukee a 5-point up now. 5-point advantage for the Milwaukee Bucks as Jim Price looks inside and guns. Benson sweeps down, outlet to Walton, a 6-foot guard from Marquette. Almost threw it away. Now Milwaukee has gotten hot again, and they open up a 7-point lead with 7:24 to play in the first half.
Junior Bridgman's a very fine shooter, and he can put some points up very quickly. The Pistons cannot allow him an open jump shot.
And the Pistons want to talk it over. Let's watch that last steal.
Here you'll see Lloyd Walton come up. Who says there isn't a place for the little man in the game? Just take it on in, Lucky. Shoemate coming over to challenge.
Great replay.
And he puts it up with the left hand.
And Milwaukee leads by 7.
Up here, the wind can turn an entire ski slope into one big snowdrift. But you're going to take the mountain away from the storm and give it back to the skiers. Now comes Miller time. Time to head for the best tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
If you've got the time.
If you've got the time.
We've got the beer.
Port of call, South Pacific.
Liberty call, Liberty call.
The Navy. See a recruiter or call toll free. It's not just a job, it's an adventure.
Enjoying the trip in your GM car?
Oh, yes.
Want to keep that great GM feeling?
Oh, yes.
Then shake hands with Mr. Goodwrench. He's dedicated to improved customer care at more than 6,000 participating GM dealers.
You want genuine GM parts. You want your car fixed right on time. That's what I want, too. Caring about your GM car helps keep me in business.
Keep that great GM feeling with genuine GM parts.
Join hosts Mary Tyler Moore and Walter Cronkite with 120 of CBS's brightest stars for the gala celebration, CBS On the Air.
Now for a report on the Chicago-Cleveland game, let's go to Gary Bender and Steve Jones in Cleveland.
And
a happy Easter to those fans who have been watching that Detroit-Milwaukee basketball game. We're here in the Richfield Coliseum in the red uniforms, the dark uniforms, the Chicago Bulls meeting the Cleveland Cavaliers. 6:51 to go in the second period, and Chicago trails in this game 36-23. Chicago had cut it to four after one period, but now Cleveland's on the move again as Furlow is fouled.
Well, Terry Furlow gets fouled as he comes across the middle that time. You'll see that Cleveland right now just has a better offensive unit out on the floor, and they're getting the better chances to shoot the ball. Tate Armstrong being misused on defense. That's his second foul in scoring situation. Woody Walker the first one, and now Terry Furlow, he puts him on the line, and Furlow is going to pick up his 6 point.
Terry Furlow coming in here and giving the Cleveland Cavaliers a real shot in the arm. Gary Bender along with Steve Jones at the Richfield Coliseum. Two teams desperately struggling to get into the playoffs. The Bulls, with seven games remaining, they've got to win all seven of them.
The interesting thing that we should note about the Cleveland Cavaliers is they have had leads in the first half and really have struggled to hold them, so the Chicago Bulls have a chance to get back in this basketball game.
Bingo Smith comes up with a steal. The veteran from Tulsa, puts Walker having a good first half. Lambert playing in place of Elmore Smith, who's out with four fouls. Lambert giving him some quickness. Here's Furlow in the corner. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Bingo Smith. Rebound cleared by Shepard, who has 8 points in the game. Here comes Tate Armstrong. So it's 6 minutes to go in the second period. It's 38-23, Cleveland leading Chicago.
And we welcome you back to Milwaukee. This is Don Cricky with John McLaughlin. You see our score is now Milwaukee 40, Detroit 33. The Pistons rallied back to within one again, and then Milwaukee got its running game going, got a couple of overmatches and a couple of fast break layups. Now, the three defensive board is taken down by Junior Bridgman of the Bucks, and they come back down the floor looking to annex their biggest lead of the game. If they hit here, they'll be up by nine. But Detroit, every time they get down, rallies right back. And here is the Pistons forcing a turnover. Shumate taking the ball as Ford brings it up.
Now, the Pistons are aware of Lucky Lloyd Walton. He's on Ford. Therefore, they're trying to take advantage of him whenever they can, but they don't want to get completely out of their offense to do it.
Ford's a 6'5", Walton's a 6'. Leon Douglas going to the basket is called for a travel prior to his shot, and so there is no basket, and the ball turns back over to Milwaukee.
Turnovers can hurt you so many ways. Actually, in that situation, Detroit would have had 2 points, but with the turnover, they get none.
The second period clock shows 5:25 to play. Walton guns it over to Dave Myers with a beautiful driving hook layup a little bit ago, and now kicks it out to Benson, and Benny, as they call him, knocks down his third and fourth points with a field goal, and it's 42-33, and Detroit is down by the biggest margin. The Pistons have trailed by nine. Feed off to ML Carr from Douglas. Nicely done.
The Pistons are so very good inside. They run what they call the fist play for the big guys inside, and they really post up very well, and that time they got two out of it.
ML Carr now has 10 points, as does his teammate Eric Money for Detroit. English, who hasn't shot the ball for some time, can't get this one down. And here comes Carr at 6'6", trying to lose English behind the back. Myers doubling up on the ball. Milwaukee does a real good job teaming up, but this time they leave the man open, and Leon Douglas takes it right in.
Once again, the Pistons going inside. ML Carr knowing the big guys. Douglas had Junior Bridgman on him. The Bucks getting switched off, and even when they don't get switched off, Detroit still has a lot of size.
Leon Douglas intercepts. As the Pistons, down by nine, can now rally back to within three if they hit here. It's 42-37 Milwaukee. Chris Ford goes to ML Carr down low. They try to get it into Jim Price, and the ball is taken away by Lloyd Walton to Myers. Cocks that ball like a catcher, but nobody's open to go to.
A lot of turnovers in this game by both clubs. Right now, Detroit 13, Milwaukee 11.
Junior Bridgman kind of cruises out outer perimeter and fire something up from 25, and Junior Bridgman has now scored 10 points coming off the bench for Milwaukee. Price comes right back as both teams are hot now, knocking everything down, and the tempo stays fast as Bridgman takes it down. 3:35 to play in the first half. 44-39. Milwaukee in the lead. Walton gets a free shot from the flank and hits it.
Both clubs, in their attempt to double up on the ball at times, are leaving people open. Price the last time, this time Lucky Lloyd Walton.
Where does he get that name, Lucky? That wasn't.
He just says, I'm lucky to be here, so his name is Lucky.
At 6 feet, happy to be here.
It's maybe 6 feet if you lay him down and pull on each end.
Third round draft choice out of Marquette, now in his second year with the Milwaukee Bucks.
played all his college home games in the same arena. Walton starts to go in. Price shuts him off. Benson loses the ball. Somebody better grab it. Shoemate, nicely done. A lead to Ford. A breakaway. Benson stamps the feet, but Ford is not shaken. Lays it in. And we have a three-point game, Milwaukee.
What is it? In the guard?
Turnovers again, Don. The Bucks and Detroit are keeping pretty equal in that particular department. Shoemate made a nice play there.
One of the interesting things out here, Walton stepped down the baseline of the court, so the ball turns over to Detroit. The interesting things about turnovers, and the Celtics are winning championships every year, they used to turn the ball over more than anybody. We'll be back in a moment with Milwaukee leading 46-43.
See what's new today in a Chevrolet.
To the more than 600,000 people who bought the new Chevrolet during its very first year, thank you. You've made it the most popular car in America. For the rest of you, a simple reminder. With its advanced design, the new Chevrolet has more headroom, more rear seat legroom, more trunk room, and more. So drive it. The new Chevrolet. Now that's more like it.
Get up there. Hi, this big man here, he runs on hay at Aquapura. But this baby, she runs on gas, and that's where STP gas treatment comes in. You just pump it in your tank, and it goes to work cleaning your carburetor. It's powerful stuff. Open your mouth and say ah, sweetheart.
People joke about businessmen spending a lot of time on the golf course. Well, I'm a golfer who spends a lot of time on business. When I'm traveling, here's how I keep ahead of the paperwork. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary. I can dictate letters, memos, wherever I am. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary helps get the work done faster, which leaves more time for what I really like to do. Look for Lanier in the yellow pages under dictating machines.
On Friday night at 11:30 p.m. Eastern, CBS Sports presents NBA action with the Portland Trail Blazers taking on the Los Angeles Lakers. Followed on Sunday by regional contests with Philadelphia going against San Antonio, the Knicks tangling with Washington, Houston clashing with Denver, Milwaukee versus Detroit, and Portland at Seattle. Consult your local listings for the game and time in your area. That's NBA action next Friday night and Sunday afternoon.
Back in Milwaukee this Easter Sunday as the Milwaukee Bucks hold to a 46-43 lead over Detroit. That is a very vital factor for Milwaukee in their lead. 20-8 advantage off the bench.
The Bucks have really had this type of consistency all year from their bench. And of course, a lot of clubs in professional basketball are getting that because they're using their bench so frequently. The Pistons increasing their shooting percentage a little, Don, 63% in this particular quarter, whereas at the end of the first quarter, they're only shooting 42%.
We have 2:30 left to go in the first half. Pistons have been getting some running shots down closer. ML Carr can't get it to go, and Kent Benson takes it down and right up to the littlest man on the floor, Lloyd Walton. Back to Benson. He can fire from out there. But Karam's out to lead a piston break. Milwaukee gets back quickly on defense as Ben Poquette is now in the game for Detroit. Shoemate fires, hit early from out there, then missed a couple, and here comes Lloyd Walton down the middle, lanes fill as Walton feeds off to Alex English. Myers works hard and taps it out to English. Tries to get it to Bridgman, and the ball comes inbound to the Pistons. Myers sure does work hard.
That's right, he does. He works all the time. Dave helps out tremendously, not only offensively and going to the basket, but he's always every place on the court to help out defensively.
His sister is an All-American women's basketball player for UCLA.
Dave says she's the best athlete in the family.
There's 11 of them. There's got to be
right.
Some good ones. Walton.
Oh.
He's got some tricks, this little guy from Marquette.
Who says there isn't room for the little guy in basketball, right?
Happy to be here. Lloyd Walton doing a number now. It's 48-43 with 1:20 left to play in the first half. Milwaukee holding to a five-point lead. Shoemate takes a look. He's trying to work on Benson. He's going to jump it up.
Benny doing a nice play here on the post up. And look at the play on Lucky Lloyd Walton. Coming in, the big guy comes over to challenge, and he does a little dipsy-doo for two.
All right, then, Lloyd Walton. Now we have Milwaukee with the ball and a 5-point lead. 1:10 left to play in the first half. Last night, we joined us late. Golden State beat New York 133-123, so the Golden State Warriors are only a game behind Milwaukee in the loss column, and that bid for the final playoff spot in the West. Alex English trying to shoot inside, and he's fouled.
Now, the Bucks that time coming up, calling a set play, and they're executing it very nicely. They go through a lot of gyration just to post up Alex English, but they have a lot of confidence in his ability inside. He can get up high enough to get the shot off, and he has good control. That time, he draws the foul.
English has now scored 7 points. He was drafted in the second round after making second team All-America at South Carolina. With less than a minute to go, the ball is up court to Chris Ford. Kent Benson working hard, trying to get to the ball. And Ford takes it right in, puts it up over all the big guys. Myers and Benson will right up to try and block it, be in enough arc to get it down.
Middle.
And it's a 49-45 game. Milwaukee by four. English with his own offensive rebound. Big job by Alex English.
English has done an excellent job this year at times. He hasn't sustained any consistency of going to the offensive boards. Tonight, today, he's doing it.
English now has 10. As you see, that is the first half winding down to 22 seconds. An air ball comes down to Benson, but Chris Ford gets it back. And now things get a little bit sloppy, and Lloyd Walton says, here, fellas, let me handle this thing.
I don't know if they know what color their uniforms are.
Walton puts up a bizarre type of an effort, and a foul is signaled on Walton.
Well, that was a charge situation. Actually, the Bucks didn't play that too smart. They had plenty of time the first time they got the ball. They should have just walked the ball up and ran a play.
ML Carr with the first half about to end. And he hands it right to Dave Myers before he can fire a full court hope. The buzzer sounds, and the first half comes to an end. Milwaukee Bucks holding to a 51-45 lead. They led by as many as 9 in the second period. And Detroit, after getting behind, invariably rallied back into the game. There's a couple of other big games going around. We'll be switching to them to update you as the Milwaukee Bucks fighting for that sixth and final playoff position lead at the half here. Now for a report on Portland and Philadelphia. Let's go to Brent Musburger and Keith Erickson in Philadelphia.
Welcome, those of you who are watching Detroit and Milwaukee. We have just seen Joe Bryan of Philadelphia put in the free throw that put the 76ers up by 5 as Jelly Bean tries to hit 2 in a row. We've got 2:55 to go in the first half. And the Blazers in a bit of foul trouble as well as injury trouble. Calhoun with 4, Hollins with 4, Hollins out. Torzic, Davis in the backcourt, and Davis, Dunn, Owens. They go, and Jackie Dorsey, who was picked up. What league was he playing in? Was it the Eastern League?
I believe it was the Eastern League.
We've got the Eastern League, the Continental League, the City League. They've even approached Keith Erickson prior to this game to see if they could suit him up. Dawkins. 2:24 to go in the half. Sixers lead the Blazers 49-43.
That is the score at the half here at Milwaukee. The Bucks holding to a 51-45 lead. Coming up next is the horse competition. You'll see the big power forward of Portland, Maurice Lucas, in today's competition. That'll be coming up in a moment.
Mr. Heidblum?
Huh?
Mr. Heidblum.
Yes?
Yeah, look, we understand that you're taking a trip with us tomorrow.
Trip?
Yeah, well, we want you to know that Avis is working right now.
Avis?
It's vacuuming your car, checking the oil, brakes, even the air in the spare tire.
Spare tire.
One of the ways Avis tries harder is working at night, so you're ready in the morning. Yeah. Oh, by the way, it's a Chrysler Cordoba, and it's blue. See you in the morning.
See you in the morning.
We try harder, Avis. Avis, we don't know another way.
Penn makes more tennis balls than anyone in America. Tested electronically for quality and response. Penn tennis balls to give you long play, lively bounce, and consistent performance off the racket. Penn, the official ball of World Team Tennis.
Russell Jim Simpson for Valvoline Motor Oil. Trackside for the start of Houston's rush hour traffic.
Where everyday drivers by the thousands prove that Valvoline is one motor oil that's not just for winning races.
For a closer look, here is A.J. Foyt.
Thanks, Jim. The only thing racing down here are the temperatures in these cars' engines. That's why they need a tough motor oil like Valvoline.
There you have it, from an expert. What are you waiting for? Valvoline Motor Oil is not just for winning races.
Leslie Caron for Color Track by RCA.
In Gigi, my brooch was blue, the leaves were green, and my gown was lavender lace. If these colors don't look right to you, you should know about Color Track from RCA. Getting the color right is what Color Track is all about. It actually adjusts the colors and locks them on track.
Before you see the color, the Color Track system grabs it, aligns it, defines it, sharpens it, tones it, and locks the color on track.
RCA is making television better and better.
Hi, everyone. I'm Don Crickey. And this year at halftime on CBS coverage of NBA basketball, we have some of the top players in the league matched up in the old schoolyard game of horse, where a player must duplicate his opponent's shots or be assessed a penalty letter. Five misses means five letters. That spells horse, and he's out. Today, Phil Smith of Golden State goes against Maurice Lucas of Portland. For more on the rules, here's Mindy Rudolph.
The basic rules of horse are as follows. The player in control must describe a shot beforehand. Now, two consecutive shots from the same area are not allowed unless someone moves at least 5 feet away. There are trick shots allowed. However, the same trick shot cannot be attempted more than once in the contest. The flip of the coin will determine who goes first. Now, there's going to be disputes out there, and if there are, my word will be the final judge.
Phil Smith has won the toss.
You see that one, bro?
He'll lead away.
Phil Smith, first shot, go.
Bank shot. I can't shoot no banks. That's for sure.
Oop. And a miss.
He can on that occasion. And Maurice Lucas gets the shooting advantage.
Oh, we got a trick shot coming.
They got to jump. I'm going to jump out of bounds, back in. No bank board.
Big guy did it. So Smith has to match it now. Phil Smith, who once hit 51 points in an NBA game.
Bank board.
He stays right with him.
Same shot, bank board.
Big Luke gonna do it again, only use the glass this time, and he gets it down again. Both these players are fourth-year professionals. Banker. Lucas not wasting any time, and he keeps that shooting advantage. You can't lose while you have that.
Jump shot on the base.
First letter goes up on Phil Smith as Lucas continues to hit everything he throws up.
Second letter, O.
Phil Smith, one of the better jump shooters in the league, has a problem. Luke looks a little ornery. He says he plays with intelligence, and he plays rough, and nobody doubts that.
Third letter, Phil Smith, H-O-R.
Right now, Lucas has the shooting advantages. He's had whole game, and he has a shutout going.
What I got here?
What you got left in your repertoire here, huh?
What I got left. Bank shot.
Fourth letter for Smith. Call him out.
Bank shot.
So Maurice Lucas now is one letter away from closing out sharpshooter Phil Smith of Golden State. Smith has to make this or it's over.
Bank shot.
Gonna stay right with it. But that looks like the same shot twice. And that is the ruling of Mindy Rudolph. And so the shooting advantage goes to Phil Smith. Lucas cannot shoot the same shot from the same place twice in a row.
Right? Straight on, off the glass and in.
Off the glass and in. Miss, Luke, take over.
Right here, straight in.
You got it. Straight in it is.
That's the ball game.
There you go again.
So Phil Smith goes out, losing at love, and Maurice Lucas advances.
Now let's meet Maurice Lucas of the world champion Portland Trail Blazers. Maurice, you had a shutout win. We haven't had many of those.
Well, I tell you, it's a good feeling. I'm not in a great shooting position. I'm not a great shooter, but at times I find myself shooting well.
You shot real well. We'll see you in the rounds to come.
Okay.
Maurice Lucas of the Portland Trail Blazers.
A loser in the first round of this competition at the Omni International Complex in Atlanta gets a check for $500. The winner advances. Next week, it's Terry Furlow versus JoJo White.
Now, let's find out more what our friend Jimmy the Greek thinks about this sports scene today as we go to his weekly report.
Archie's dream of owning Kelsey's Bar could come true in a special one-hour edition of All in the Family, Tuesday night on CBS.
The NBA on CBS is sponsored by the new Gillette Atra Razor, the impossible shave. Selsun Blue, the dandruff shampoo in dry, normal, and oily formulas. All the new 1978 Chevrolets now at your Chevy dealers everywhere. And by Light Beer, everything you've always wanted in a beer and less.
As no doubt you're aware, Bob Lanier, the all-pro center for Detroit, underwent knee surgery on Friday. He'll be out for the remainder of the season. For more on his injury condition and his outlook on the playoffs, we talk with Bob Lanier before the start of today's game.
Bob, we're very sorry that you're not in the lineup, but also happy to learn that everything's coming along. I guess you're expecting to be back at full speed next season.
Yeah, I hope so. He said, well, they were going to let me out of here today, but I had a little temperature, so they want me to stick around here and make sure nothing else goes wrong. I think they're going to keep me around here for another couple of days.
Bob, you've played against everybody. Would you pick any one team going into the playoffs as possibly the one to beat?
Well, I think the dark horse in the race might be the Lakers right now. I think they're playing pretty well. They got some good leadership. All the guys are coming to play. And, of course, you know Philly's going to be there. And I'm thinking Portland might not be as strong with all these guys being injured and you know, getting that unity back together again.
All right, Bob, well, continued success and good wishes for a quick recovery. I look forward to seeing you back on the court soon.
Okay, good luck to my Pistons today.
All right.
Bob Lanier. Now for a report on the Sea Pines Heritage Classic Golf Tournament. It's being played in South Carolina. You'll see it on CBS. Let's go to Vin Scully for an update.
Blustery winds are complicating matters for the final round of the Heritage Golf Classic. Even though you get on the leaderboard when you hit the backside of this great course, you'll have to hang on with both hands or you'll be blown off. Right now, Larry Nelson, who had never won a tournament, for that matter, had never led at the end of three rounds, he has been caught by David Graham, so they are seven under par. Right behind them, Lou Graham at six under, and then you have Hale Irwin, who has won this tournament twice in 1971 and in 73, followed by Ben Crenshaw and last year's PGA champion Lanny Watkins. One of the great touches to the Heritage Classic, the fact that Sam Snead, who will be 66 in May, not only survived the cut, but on this final round, shot a par 71. To complicate matters for Sam, he had an ingrown toenail on his right foot, so his right golf shoe was 1.5 sizes larger than the left shoe. But it didn't faze old Sam. He threw a 71 on the board. But that's the story at this stage of the final round. Larry Nelson, David Graham at 7 under, with Lou Graham right behind them, and a trio just 2 shots back. It's going to be great. Be with us at 4 p.m. Eastern time, what should be a marvelous finish. Right now, let's go back to NBA basketball.
All right, Vin, at the conclusion of today's game and each of our NBA telecasts during the season, we'll be selecting the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player of the Game. In conjunction with this award, Chevrolet will present a check for $1,000 to the General Scholarship Fund of the Players College or University. Any student may be eligible to benefit from these scholarship funds, and today's winner will be announced at the end of the telecast. John, you and I will be voting for the MVP, and should we disagree, our producer, David Fox, will cast the deciding vote.
So we have both clubs back on the floor. Milwaukee, as you remember, led by a single point at the end of the first period. And now as we start into the third period, the Bucks are holding to a six-point lead, 51-45. They shot very well overall in the first half.
They did. A lot of turnovers, though. See, Detroit Pistons 17, the Milwaukee Bucks 16. And I don't know if that's just because of poor ball handling or the tight defense. I think there is an intensity defensively, and I think you expect that when a big game is being played as is today.
Well, Milwaukee, of course, is hopeful of getting through this game without having to use Marcus Johnson, who has the injured shoulder. So far, they've not played him, and they're holding to a lead. That's the first half breakdown. Detroit did not shoot bad, 48%. Didn't have many free throws, though. Only two did they take and made but one. That's been a difference, as Milwaukee has hit 5 of 7. Rebounding is even up. Assists pretty much even. Turnovers, they've both been turning the ball over regularly, and they've both been stealing the ball also. A lot of people going after it, a lot of double teaming on the ball.
Both clubs pretty much playing the same type of defense. I mentioned that briefly during the first half. They want to push to the sides, and both clubs aware of double teaming, the Milwaukee Bucks in particular. And here's the Detroit team scoring. Ford coming in with a quick 10, Carr and Money scoring 10. Money putting up some points very quickly in only 15 minutes, shooting very well. You can see it as it carries on out there. But Ford and Money in particular have the ability to put a lot of points on very quickly. Milwaukee Bucks, Junior Bridgman coming in off the bench and leading them with 10.
Buckner and Winters did not score in the second period for Milwaukee, but they've got good bench. And here is Buckner leading off right away. The basic kick and roll as the lead pass comes in from Alex English. 8-point advantage now for the Bucks. How does their schedule look the rest of the way, John?
Well, the Bucks have a pretty tough schedule. I think Golden State might have the best situation, but none of them are that good. All the clubs are pretty tough.
John Shumate muscles his way in and draws a shooting foul from Ginelli. So Shumate now will work to the line and try for the 3-point play.
This is John Shumate at his best. He gets inside, and once he gets the ball in this deep, it's going to be 2 points or possibly three.
Shumate, of course, came to Detroit this season from Buffalo, along with Gus Gerard, who's now out with an injury, unfortunately, for the invisible man who went to Buffalo, Marvin Barnes.
He must have some problems, but he certainly can play the game when he wants to.
It is 53-48 now. 5-point lead for Milwaukee. Bucks have the ball, work a little bit of a weave on the outside, setting picks off it, looking for that open man in there. Myers fires from way out. Myers gunning it from way out. Easy bank shot. Hits down. It's 55-48 Bucks.
Dave Myers will go to the glass quite a bit. He uses it very well. The Bucks once again trying to double team Money. It's like Buckner should be called for the foul.
Second personal.
He now has two.
Piston ball.
Wayne Buckner with a second personal foul. Eric Money, Chris Ford working inside. Money can't get it down. Alex English, you really can just cruise up.
He really glides around out there, doesn't he?
He's a smooth basketball player, a 6'7", who can really get up. So light on his feet. He's looking down low to get the ball against ML Parr. He's got a little bit of a height advantage.
Scott Miller to the police room.
That's enough.
Carr and English going out inside. The Bucks trying to post up English in that particular situation. ML Carr knows it, and he's trying to keep the ball away from him.
So Carr gets his first personal foul. Ryan Winters is left free. He doesn't miss too many of those open shots. Can't get that one down. And here comes Detroit.
Actually, Winters, that's only his fifth shot in the game. I would expect him to shoot a lot more than that.
Chris Ford with a good drive, but the reject by John Ginelli. Back to Ford and tapped up and in by Leon Douglas.
Douglas is doing a nice job of hanging around the boards, and that's a situation where the Bucks gave help, and that left Douglas open. That's the guard's responsibility to come back in there and try to block the big guy out on the weak side.
And somebody's always supposed to be blocking out the opposing center off the offensive board. Myers down low to Ginelli. Good inside play from the opposing centers on subsequent possessions, and now it is 57-50 Milwaukee. Myers takes the rebound before he does. We have a loose ball foul signaled against Leon Douglas.
You see the ball get inside to Douglas, and he takes a big step, and he gets up into his shot. Doesn't really concentrate like his coach would like for him to do. Bob Kaufman said that. But you see a loose ball foul. Dave Myers going up to get it, coming down to the floor.
Listen up, team. It's a long ride to Hog Flats.
Yeah, all day long.
So starch is going to pass out the right guard deodorant.
We got stick or spray.
With right guard deodorant, stick or spray protects all day. They don't just cover up odor, they help stop odor before it starts.
All day long.
And it's going to be a long day.
Yeah. Right guard deodorant. Don't get dressed without it.
Impossible.
America's waking up to the impossible shave. Gillette Atra. The first razor with a head that pivots to follow every contour of your face. For closeness with comfort you never thought possible.
Impossible.
This Atra face-hugging action keeps twin blades at the perfect angle.
Such closeness with so much comfort, it's impossible!
Gillette Atra. Yes, the impossible shave is here.
We all have dandruff. But that doesn't mean my hair is like hers.
Or mine like theirs.
Now Selsun Blue, the shampoo famous for controlling dandruff, has some beautiful news for you.
Selsun Blue introduces three new formulas.
With extra conditioners for dry hair.
With extra cleansers for oily hair.
Properly balanced for normal hair.
Fresh, clean new fragrance, too.
So now you can treat your dandruff.
And treat yourself to great-looking hair.
With Selsun Blue.
For dry,
normal,
or oily hair.
Premiering Sunday, April 2nd, Dallas, where money buys power and passion breeds conflict. Larry Hagman and Patrick Duffy star in Dallas.
And there is the head coach of the Detroit Pistons, Bob Kauffman, who took over 18 games into this season from Herb Brown. As right now, Kauffman and the Pistons are trailing in this game to Milwaukee 57-50. We have 9:55 to play in the third period. Quinn Buckner comes up court with the ball, has it tipped away by Eric Money. And they call an over and back on Quinn Buckner.
Buckner trying to wait for the ball to come back over the 10-second line. Finally decided I better pick it up here. Money might take it.
Has Nelson had, he hasn't had too many technical fouls, has he?
Yes, yeah. As a matter of fact, Don Nelson, I think, is second in the NBA behind Kevin Locker.
He maintains himself and he's performing quite well here today.
No one will catch Kevin, though. He's the coach the Knicks.
Well, Will Reed on games coached, he's doing pretty good.
I think he's catching up fast. Gets expensive.
And Billy Cunningham has done well. He could go right into the fourth for 6 games.
That's right.
6 fewer games to win.
All of them happen to be ex-players, don't they?
Yeah. Here's Buckner. Down to Brian Winters, firing from the outside. And Brian Winters, the leading scorer for the Milwaukee Bucks on the season. Knocks down another field goal from the outside. He has 11 points in Milwaukee. Opens up a 9-point lead, 59-50. With 9:10 to play in the third period. Myers with the steal, but he threw the ball away.
The Bucks coming up. They scored the last time on a pick-and-roll situation with a double screen for Brian Winters on the weak side. This time the Pistons trying to do the same thing. The Bucks forcing it back into the corner. And we now have a technical foul on Quinn Buckner. Buckner doesn't understand what he said.
Quinn Buckner.
And Earl's trying to explain to him what he said.
Well, John Schumann, he was all lined up right at the free throw line right away. As soon as he saw that T come up, he's a designated shooter.
Get those free ones.
Never in doubt. Right on down. It's a 59-51 game, and Detroit will inbound the ball. They're working with Chris Ford.
That might be the first technical foul, I'm not sure, right off that Quinn Buckner's had all season.
Here is Chris Ford down low to Leon Douglas, and we have some big people bumping inside. That'll be a foul call. There's another technical.
Buckner is out of the game. One Earl Strom is one of the officials you do not want to mess with. He won't take a lot. And it's very uncharacteristic of Quinn Buckner.
Quinn called it a day, and then he was out of here right pronto. He will take these all afternoon if they give them to him. Very, very happy to have them.
Well, you love those. Now, Earl, the fans reacting a little bit to Earl here. Earl Strom, the official.
into the lineup.
By the way, Earl Strom is an excellent official.
Yes, he is. And I'll tell you one thing, there's no amount of crowd noise or player noise or people right. shouting and throwing that's going to shake him either.
That's for sure.
He won't back down.
Junior Bridgman in for Quinn Buckner.
Here's Leon Douglas working inside, rejected beautifully by Alex English. And the ball is over to Junior Bridgman. And those successive technical fouls bring this crowd alive now as Ginelli gets the ball down low to Alex English. He starts to move to the basket for Milwaukee. And Detroit comes off with the ball. The Pistons down by 7, inching their way back. And Leon Douglas loses the ball. And it's ruled last touch by Dave Myers.
There was intention coming into this game, Don. It's picking up quite a bit now, and the fans helping.
Chris Ford takes it up court against Junior Bridgman. He played so well in the second period, coming off the bench. Bridgman came in to score 10 points for Milwaukee. Leon Douglas lost the handles. He went to the basket, but he did draw the shooting foul for Detroit.
The Bucks are going to have to react to that pick and roll a little bit better. Douglas, money, do it very nicely. It's very simple. You'll see here the pick, Douglas rolling. Brian Winters trying to get into the passing lane, but he was entirely too late. Weak side helped by the Bucks and the foul.
Junior Bridgman gets his second personal foul. And so now we have 8:19 to play in the third period, and the Pistons are back at the free throw line. Douglas shooting for his 8th point.
Correction, 14 fouls.
And Leon Douglas will go right back now to try the second shot, fouled in the act of shooting. He can make it a 5-point game. So the Bucks come up the floor with the basketball now. Their lead of 9 cut down to 5, 59 to 54. We have 8:15 to play in the third period. Chris Ford harassing Brian Winters. Winters gets the free shot. It's partially blocked by Leon Douglas. He tipped it out of bounds. Milwaukee will inbound the ball. John?
A lot of banging going on now. Chris Ford coming up to play Brian Winters, banging him a little bit. It looked like Brian might have turned the ball over trying to get away from him. And Douglas coming out to block the shot. He can block shots.
Douglas can get up there. And he's very, very quick. Deceptively quick. He takes one big step and all of a sudden he's up in the air and slapping it back at you. Here comes Alex English. And now we have a whistle from Hugh Evans inside.
Well, the Bucks had a mismatch. Ford on Dave Myers. Dave Myers trying to post up and Ford using his body a little too much. Gut call.
Bridgman against Chris Ford. They're looking to work a play down low to Brian Winters. Tipped away by Shoemate. Back inbounds to Milwaukee.
The Pistons doing a lot of switching on the Bucks set stuff. That time it was a double screen for Brian Winters and Shoemate switched out and knocked the ball away.
Frozen base, Chrissy. Frozen base.
Bridgman throws to Ginelli. Chris Ford gets the loose ball. English getting back to defend. And Chris Ford cannot pull up to take the shot. Back to Shoemate, and here's Eric Money. Leon Douglas sets himself low. They're looking to work a pick and roll, but he cannot get the ball to Leon Douglas. Ford comes up with it. Milwaukee harassing the man with the ball. Here's the clock. Back up. And Leon Douglas gets it to work. And now Detroit has rallied back to within 3. Ryan Winters scoops down the floor, and John Shoemate sweeps off the defensive board. And Detroit, down by 9, can rally back to within 1. The Pistons playing good, heady basketball. They're giving the ball up, looking for the open man, and they've rallied back to within 1.
That was a very difficult shot by Ford, but the Pistons doing it with defense. Ford making a steal and starting to play the passing lanes a little bit more and applying the pressure to the Bucks. The Bucks taking some forced shots.
Now Milwaukee coach Don Nelson's going to go to a little muscle in the game. He's going to put Ernie Grunfeld in. Ginelli tries to throw low to Alex English. The ball was last touched by Detroit.
The Bucks starting to rattle a little bit with the defensive intensity by the Pistons, and they cannot do that. They must continue to run the break and also come up when they don't have the break and execute their half-court offense, which they are not doing.
See what's new today.
Introducing the third generation Monte Carlo. The third generation of a highly successful personal luxury car. Its highly original styling opens new dimensions in affordable luxury. And in comfort. With more rear seat headroom, legroom, and hip room than last year's Monte Carlo, the third generation Monte Carlo. Drive it and put a little distance between yourself and the crowd.
When you order a beer, do like Smokin' Joe.
Order live beer from Miller
and say no more. It's got the third less calories than the regular beer. Light tastes great, y'all, but listen here. It's not the thing that makes me shout. Light's less filling, hey, that really knocks me out.
us.
Wherever you may roam, you'll find our name is known. You can trust Delco.
Thanks, Delco.
Delco Freedom Battery.
I trust Delco batteries. And my reputation rides on Delco shock absorbers. Because you never know when you're going to need Delco's smooth control.
When the road is curved and rough, you need the shock that's tough. You can trust Delco.
Thanks, Delco.
Delco shocks and batteries. Delco shocks and batteries.
Thanks, Delco.
Next Sunday, April 2nd at 4 p.m. Eastern, CBS Sports presents live coverage of the United States Grand Prix West with defending champion Mario Andretti, 1977 Grand Prix champion Niki Lauda, and more racing through the streets of Long Beach. That's next Sunday at 4 p.m. Eastern.
So we're ready to go again here in the third period as the 10 men come back out onto the playing floor in a game that's really heated up. Milwaukee's lead of 9, now down to 1, as Detroit has run off 8 straight points. The Bucks will inbound the ball. Grunfeld set to put it in play as they set the inbound play. Bridgman at the free throw line, and Walton breaks off. And Bridgman gets free and knocks it down. Nicely done by Milwaukee.
The team foul situation, the Bucks have 4 and Detroit 3. So on the next foul by the Bucks, the Pacers will be in the penalty.
Offensive foul is signaled against Detroit, and the ball is back over to Milwaukee.
Detroit coming back that time with their meat and potatoes play. That's the pick and roll, but it didn't work. The foul call.
So we have 61-58 on the board. We welcome our Cleveland-Chicago viewers. That's Chris Ford of Detroit hitting the field goal. Detroit has rallied from 9 points down in this third period. The trail Milwaukee, the team in the white uniforms, by a single point now. 61-60, Milwaukee in the lead. This is Don Cricky with John McLaughlin. He had successive technical fouls signaled against Quinn Buckner. He is out of the game now because of that. And Detroit with the free throws, the technical foul shots by Shumate, and then some possessions and some quick field goals, got right back in it. Detroit playing very hard ball, and as ML Carr goes to the basket, we have a whistle and a foul.
The Bucks starting to rush their offense a little too much. The Pistons playing the passing lanes very nice, so we get an opportunity to look at this last play. The ball goes up to Carr. He tries to go baseline. Grunfeld on him. He gets in position. Gianelli comes from the weak side to take the charge. Very nice.
And so, with 5:47 to play in the third period, Lloyd Walton, a 6-foot backcourt player from Marquette, tries the jump shot, does not go, but he drew the shooting foul. This has been an unusual game in that Milwaukee has had control most of the time. They build up big leads, and then Detroit invariably rallies back as they have now to trail by just 1. So Detroit, battling Milwaukee 61-60 with 5:43 to play in the third period.
Tim Price returning to the Pistons lineup.
Lloyd Walton has scored 7 points so far for the Bucks.
Now it's important for Walton to get the Bucks back into their game, to start running. If they don't have the break to stop, set up their offense and don't rush their shots. On the other end, it's important for Detroit to continue to do what they've been doing so well, tightening up the defense, playing the passing lanes, running the break when they have it, but we have a steal.
Lloyd Walton steals the ball, and Chris Ford very wisely hooks him on the arm and gets the whistle because Lloyd Walton had a breakaway.
Well, Ford normally handles the ball very nicely, and he's very deceiving in this area. Look at Walton come up, play the ball well, go after it, and Ford grabs him to keep him away from it and gets caught.
Well, he had a sure two on the breakaway. Now he's got to make it from 15 feet. One at a time.
That's right.
And he's only a 63% free throw shooter.
It was a good foul. Excellent foul.
It is now a 63-60 game. Milwaukee with a 3-point lead.
Well, that made it a very good foul.
Yep, only got half of it. And Shumate takes the rebound. Gianelli pressures the ball, so the big man, John Shumate. Fourth year from Notre Dame brings the ball over the timeline. Here's Jim Price back in now for Detroit. Chris Ford, low percentage shot. Myers sweeps it off. Here comes Walton, 10 men running. They are in the third period, 5:15 to play. Bridgman fires off the left.
That was beautiful. Junior Bridgman, he lost Ford completely, faking over the top, dropping into the corner, and Lloyd Walton doing what he is supposed to do, quarterbacking the club, saw it all happen and made the play.
And Bridgman, very quietly, although the last one had a lot of noise to it, has become the leading scorer in the game with 14, and Milwaukee leads by 5.
We're saving $600.
We're saving.
This family has rented a Ryder truck.
We're saving.
And moved 500 miles.
We're saving $600.
By packing and moving themselves, they saved a lot of money over what professional movers wanted. True, when you rent a Ryder truck, you have to do the work yourself.
We're saving $600.
But if you just keep repeating how much money you're saving, you'll be amazed how much lighter those cartons will seem.
We're saving $600.
I've got colors that will sing. I've got colors that surprise. I've got colors that will bring music to your eyes. When you choose a Pittsburgh paint, all you do is visualize. And the dealer blends the paint. That's music to your eyes. Pittsburgh paints. Music to your eyes. Pittsburgh paints. Music to your eyes.
Where are you going, America?
To Malibu.
Malibu. Malibu.
Malibu. Malibu.
Looks like a large slice of America is going to Malibu. Chevy's new size, quick size, mid-size car that's so right in so many ways for so many people right now. You'd think it had been designed by Mr. John Q. Public himself. It's you, America. A fresh new slice of apple pie called Chevy Malibu.
A fresh new slice of apple pie from Chevrolet to you.
You're going to eat it up.
Next Sunday at 1 p.m. Eastern, Challenge of the Sexes features a bowling contest with Paula Sperber Carter taking on former Rookie of the Year, Tommy Hudson. A motorcycle challenge with two-time Grand National Champion Jay Springsteen going against Diane Cox. Plus a log rolling contest. That's next Sunday at 1 p.m. Eastern.
Very lovely young Milwaukeean. Milwaukeeite, whatever it is. Here is Chris Ford fighting for the ball as everybody's after it now. We've got a 5-point lead for Milwaukee, and we're going to jump it up.
I just wanted to make the comment before that play took place that the Bucks can pressure Detroit probably very effectively now with money out of the game, Price, and Ford having to handle it in the backcourt.
The tip is controlled by Chris Ford, but very briefly, now he's got the ball. You've got to work very hard to keep the ball in this match. It's Brian Crow, that ball. Jim Price takes a look as ML Carr sets a pick, a moving pick, and he breaks away from Grunfeld, and ML Carr tries to get up inside, no foul, the rebound's down to Leon Douglas. Too much on it. Myers, defensive board. At 6'8", he'll take the breakdown floor. The big guy from UCLA.
Oh. That's mine all the way. Jimmy Price trying to take the charge, but he was a little too deep under the basket to do it.
End to end. I think Leon Douglas is hurting. He's not moving too much in time. Offensive foul against Detroit. Ball is back over to Milwaukee. Here it is again.
Here's the play by Dave Myers. He gets it in the backcourt. He's a very, very quick guy for his size. And watch where he takes off on this dunk. Free throw line, dotted line. Dunk, Jimmy Price trying to take it, but Jimmy back up. That's smart.
We've had 39 turnovers in the game. 20 for Detroit, 19 for Milwaukee. And it'll be back inbounds now to the Bucks as they lead the game 67-60. So the form chart holding up as this game has run with Milwaukee inching ahead. And then invariably Detroit climbing back into the game. Bridgman fires. And again, Milwaukee is enjoying its biggest lead of the game. They've had it before, 9 points.
I think Junior's only missed two shots in this game. He missed one in the first half, and I recall one in the second.
Junior is the leading scorer on the floor. Junior Bridgman with 16 points. Ben Poquette.
Douglas out of the game. He hurt his hip on a particular play there. I don't know which one it was, Poquette in.
Junior Bridgman doing it all right now. Takes it down off the defensive board. He's going to go the distance if he can. No, it goes over to Myers. And Milwaukee all of a sudden is ripping it open, and Detroit's going to call a timeout. They're up and cheering here in Milwaukee as the Bucks get their running game going. 3:26 left to play in the third period, and Milwaukee breaks open the game, if but for the moment.
The Bucks really running. They've tightened up their defense, and that's, of course, so very important to them because they do rely on their running game. Detroit so far in the game, Shumate has 13 points, Ford 14, Carr 10, and Money 10, with Douglas 11, and with him out of the game, that could hurt Detroit quite a bit. For the Milwaukee Bucks, Junior Bridgman firing in 16, 9 for English, 9 for Winters. Buckner out of the game with 9. Lucky Lloyd Walton with 10. Dave Myers. Lucky Lloyd Walton with 8. Dave Myers with a big 10. Getting good balance out of the Milwaukee Bucks.
Now for a report on the Portland-Philadelphia game, let's go to Brent Musburger and Keith Erickson in Philadelphia.
Welcome now, those of you who have been watching Milwaukee-Detroit. When last you checked with us, it was close. Milwaukee now has gone ahead by 11, but here in the Spectrum, the superior 76ers firepower has taken charge with 3:50 to go in the third. Dawkins' free throw puts the 76ers up 77-65. Not only are the Blazers without five men because of injuries, but Lionel Hollins has fouled out. No, offense is the call. Dawkins says, little man, how can you do that to me?
That's not all he said, Brent.
You got the rest of the sentence.
I don't say those kind of words anymore.
Jackie Dorsey, one of those recruited by Harry Glickman to fill this breach. Davis comes up on Lloyd free, went high off the glass. 11 points for Davis. So with 3:21 to go in the third, it's 77-67, the Sixers in command.
We welcome back our viewers now here at Milwaukee. The Bucks in the white uniforms have opened up an 11-point or 9-point lead now, 71-62. As the Pistons moving quickly, Al Skinner in the game hit the last field goal for Detroit to bring them with 9. That's Skinner with the ball, getting it back to Eric Money. This is Don Quickie with John McLaughlin. Here is play stop as Shumate and Myers are pushing each other.
There's a lot of pushing and shoving going on. Shumate has a lot to say to Dave Myers because it's getting very physical. Shumate pushing Myers off, and the foul call on Dave Myers, that is. Now, the important thing to remember here is that there's a lot of time in this game. The Bucks got it going early. They must sustain what they've been doing, and that's defensive intensity and fast breaking, because that's when they're at their best. But there's still 2:40 to go in the third.
A lot of time left. 71-62 with 2:40, as you mentioned, John, left to play in the third period. John Shumate at the free throw line now. Shumate looking for his 14th point. Shumate started the last Detroit rally, you'll remember, when the subsequent technical fouls were called on Quinn Buckner. That was his demise. He's out for the afternoon early in the third period. Shumate hit a ball from him quickly. Detroit got right back in the game. Ginelli takes off the board now, and Milwaukee sets it up with Lloyd Walton back in the game to quarterback. Grunfeld up front along with Bridgman, Ginelli, and Myers. Bridgman is really a forward guard at 6'5". Here's Myers moving in on John Shumate. Foul call goes against Shumate.
That's a play the Bucks run for Dave Myers. When Marcus Johnson is playing, they run it for him. It's a clear out on the right side. Myers trying to take the right. Shumate playing nice defense, getting in front of Dave. He pulls up, but they still call the foul on Shumate.
In the third period, Milwaukee's been hitting 60% from the field. They hit 9 of their first 15 shots in the field. Detroit, conversely, hit only 5 of 13 for 38% in the third period. That's been the difference as Detroit now trails 71-63.
Dave Myers jump shoots his free throws. And up until early in this year, he did not shoot them that way, and he was shooting very poorly. And since he's changed and gone to the jump shot, a la Hal Greer, I'm sure many people will remember him, he's improved the shooting percentage quite a bit.
He got 2 for 1.
Detroit over the limit on fouls as Don Nelson looks on. And so the penalty is in effect for Milwaukee, and Myers has 3 chances to make 2. Sets himself like he's not going to jump, but then he springs right up. 73. Started to get like Wilton. Get to the top of the key, to the side of the lane.
Move around. He was every place, wasn't he?
And the game, he scored 100 points. What did he hit?
28 out of 32, I believe.
Right. Al Skinner thinking offense, looking to go to the basket, but he's shut off by Junior Bridgman. Now he gets it up over him. All hanging on the ring, and finally comes down to Dave Myers. Lloyd Walton takes a look and goes over to Bridgman, firing from deep outside. Aaron's right over the top of the board. It's inbounds to Detroit. In the game now for the Pistons, we have M.L. Carr, Eric Money, Al Skinner, Leon Douglas, and John Shumate. Grunfeld, Myers, Ginelli, Bridgman, and Walton in the game for Detroit. Step it up.
The Bucks did that very nicely. Again, double-teaming Money, and they wanted to make him go into the spin. And once you turn a play, the weak side guard comes over to help out. Lucky Lloyd Walton did it very nicely and tied him up.
Money gets the tap, but finally it goes over to Dave Myers. Protecting the ball. Grunfeld actually slapped it away and got it over to him. Myers points a finger at Grunfeld, saluting him for the assist. It's 75-63 Milwaukee. Leon Douglas going to the hoop. Blocking foul. It's on Milwaukee.
That's a very difficult foul to call. Earl Strom, again, I do consider him a very fine official, but Douglas posting up. Myers trying to play him with his body, and of course that's accepted to a certain extent in the NBA. Douglas jumping up. Myers supposedly has vertical air rights, but the official goes, calls the foul on Dave Myers. He's going out. Gets a round of applause. Kent Benson in.
Kent Benson comes back into the game as Dave Myers, who has been a big factor in this game. Very aggressive play, very spirited play. It's picked up the entire Milwaukee effort. Now, Leon Douglas looking to bring Detroit back to it in 10. There is Dave Myers, the consensus All-American as a senior at UCLA, led that team to a national championship. One of 11 children from Los Angeles, California. Played only about half of last season after undergoing knee surgery in 76.
That's right, and intensity really describes Dave Myers. Now, Detroit going into a zone press, but they didn't really run it that effectively.
Grunfeld can't get a shot, but he comes across court to Benson. He fires to Bridgman, and Bridgman has been so tough on the open shot, he now has 18 points. We have 105 left to play in the third period. We welcome our Cleveland, Chicago viewers as the Milwaukee Bucks are starting to run here in the third period. They've broken the game open. Kent Benson, oh man. We have a full-scale collision, and Leon Douglas has a look of, oh, what hit me?
Junior Bridgman bringing it up. Now watch Money take a charge. He passes over to Benson. Now Benson going into Douglas. It was a good call. I don't know if Douglas is going to live through this game.
Benson weighs 245, and Leon Douglas took all of it. Now it is 77-65, Milwaukee in the lead after leading by six at the half. This is Don Criggy with John McLaughlin, Eric Money. Gets it down low, and nicely to M.L. Carr. He's fouled on a play by Benson. He'll shoot for the three-point play.
That was a very nice play by the Pistons. Skinner bringing the ball up. Money coming around off of a double screen. He gets the ball, makes a beautiful play inside, and a potential three for M.L. Carr.
Junior Bridgman coming off the bench for Milwaukee has been a big factor. He's the leading scorer in the game, has scored 18. Number of the points coming on field goals. He is just kicked off to the side on the flank. They penetrate, they zing it out to him, and he's been firing down the jump shot. So Milwaukee with a great deal of pressure on this young Buck team to make the NBA playoffs, trying to stay ahead of Golden State in the Western Conference for the last spot. Milwaukee playing without Marcus Johnson so far today. He's out with a shoulder injury. Benson can't get it to work, but Ernie Grunfeld has the roll.
Ernie Grunfeld, he goes to the offensive board. He's only 6'5", but he weighs about 220. Good timing, put the ball up nicely.
Detroit comes back firing. John Shumate hits it as you see the third period clock winding down to 10 seconds. 79-70. Milwaukee in the lead and playing for the last shot of the period. Walton dishes it down low to Kent Benson. He is rejected by Leon Douglas. There's the horn, and the third period ends. So, good percentage shooting by the Milwaukee Bucks allows them to annex their lead. A lead is going into the fourth period by a 79-70 count.
By My beer from Miller tastes just great, and that's no fish story. But the best thing is, it's less filling. Light's got a third less calories than their regular beer. And that's important when you're trying to land that big one. Like yesterday, I hooked this bass, fought him for over 6 hours. All of a sudden, he jumps clean over the boat. Broke my rod, and I had to tie the... Now, wait a minute, fellas. I had to tie the
light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Left me out there with nothing but a paddle.
The NBA on CBS will continue after this word from your local station. Tonight, follow that yellow brick road to fabulous adventure with the one and only Wizard of Oz here on CBS.
First time going down. The eight faithful stay in the 100. They go drop back into a green.
We remind you to be sure and stay tuned for the MVP award at the conclusion of the game. Milwaukee's lead now 7 points over Detroit. It was 11 not that long ago as we head into the fourth period. John?
We just had a backcourt foul at the buzzer on Junior Bridgman. Alvin Skinner went to the line and made two of his three attempts. Detroit bench watching a little bit here. What's going on in between quarters? Maybe they're not too concerned about the game. I don't know. Detroit picking up the intensity a little. The Bucks better watch out. Detroit's right there, 72-79.
Junior Bridgman is the top scorer in the game with 18 points in Milwaukee. Dave Myers has started to come out. He's hit 14. And that end-to-end driving dunk shot was a big play for the Bucks in the third period. English has 9. Winters and Buckner with 9 each. That's all Buckner's going to get. He's been out since early in the third period. Two tees. Cost you a little money, too.
Yeah, a little too much. Shooting percentages in that third quarter, the Bucks 57%. Really putting it up while Detroit only shooting 30 or 40%. But that increased quite a bit down toward the end of that particular quarter.
Dave Myers scored 9 points in the third period. He's on the bench now. There is the bench scoring. Milwaukee almost doubling the output of Detroit. Eric Money looking to go to the basket against Brian Winters. Money pulling up. Rebound to Kent Benson. Richmond gets it over Brian Winters. Gianelli and Benson both in the game now. Two big men to post down low. Grunfeld. Bridgman, two small forwards also in the game along with Brian Winters. Interesting chemistry combinations that Don Nelson goes to.
Once again, the Bucks executing a play very nicely. Brian Winters orchestrating out there, telling everyone where to go, and it was a screen for Junior Bridgman, and he put it in.
Here is Leon Douglas trying to move on Benson. Douglas spins off.
Leon it down very nicely.
That big guy has played a tremendous game today. Not only offensively, always hanging around the boards, putting the pressure on the Bucks, but blocking shots and playing the defense.
In the absence of Lanier, Leon Douglas has scored 15 points so far today for Detroit.
High post, high post.
The Bucks in the white uniforms with possession of the ball have a 7-point lead. It is an 81-74 game in the fourth period. 10:50 to play in it. Richmond doesn't get that down. He hasn't missed many. And Douglas gets the ball back for Detroit. And Al Skinner crushes it up court quickly. Skinner takes it all the way.
That's what Detroit has to do. They have to advance the ball very quickly and put it in the basket. The Bucks really must make them use up as much time as possible.
Milwaukee's been able to get Detroit down, but they've been able to KO them as the Pistons rally back. Down from 11, they've come back to within 5. The lead goes to Gianelli, and we have a collision inside. If foul call against Al Skinner.
35. A lot of people going to the floor in this game. It's very physical. This is a pick and roll. Brian Winters trying to make the play to John Gianelli. Skinner coming over from the weak side to help, commits the foul. That's the first team foul on the Pistons and none on the Bucks.
In the immediate future, the Bucks don't play again until Thursday night. They'll be going against Indiana here at the Mecca. On Friday they play at New Jersey, and then next Sunday they're at Detroit again. That is Al Skinner up and about.
New Jersey 86, Washington 80.
Winters set to inbound the ball. Brian Winters with only 9 points so far, well below his 20-point a game average. Grunfeld goes to the basket. The ball was tipped last by a Detroit player.
Junior Bridgman shooting 10 for 15 in the game for 67%. And none of those, not too many of those that I recall were layups.
No, he's been hit from the deep outside. Here's Gianelli. Winners watch the big men set low, but Detroit shuffling off those picks really well, keeping Milwaukee from driving. Grunfeld gets the shot, can't get it up. The loose ball foul signaled against the Bucks. Tony Grunfeld.
The Pistons playing very fine defense, coming over to help out there, going to the boards, applying the pressure on the Bucks.
We have 9:50 left to go in the game. Money has four fouls. Shumate has four for Detroit. Gianelli, high foul man for Milwaukee with four. Myers and Bridgman have three.
M.L. Carr.
M.L. Carr getting the field goal for Detroit. All of a sudden, it's a three-point game, 81-78. Detroit just keeps inching back.
The Bucks must tighten up the defense. Detroit doing a super job of getting back in the game, running their offense, and tightening up the D. And you see Leon Douglas once again going to the boards.
Leon certainly banged up a hip earlier. Then he had Benson fall on him, you saw. Who gets that? No basket.
That was an over-the-back foul by Skinner, but once again, he's getting into that offensive board very nicely. The Bucks must block off. You see the shot go up here. Now see if you can see Skinner come into your picture. No, we really couldn't pick it up, but it was over the back.
Hugh Evans right on top of the play, and remains a three-point game. Milwaukee with the ball and the three-point lead. Here's Alex English, who shot so well when he was in earlier for the Bucks. And this time, Brian Winters can't hold on. He was the last to touch it. Detroit has it back. The Pistons can come to within one. It looked like they were out of this thing. Leon Douglas rejected by Benson. Here's a foul call.
Well, the official right on the play looked like Benson had his hand right on top of the ball. Maybe we'll get an opportunity to look at it. This is something that happens oftentimes. Don, as you see Roy Walton coming back in, Junior Bridgman out. Here's the last play. Skinner making the pass into Douglas, who's deep. Benson on him. He puts a little fake, goes up. Benson on the ball, but a little too much body.
Was it a foul?
It wasn't by the hand. Might have been by the body. You know, this can happen to a club sometimes. The Bucks got hot, they got excited, they ran that little bit of a streak, got the lead, but then they kind of let up, and the Pistons, on the other hand, just kind of hanging in there, hanging tough, whittle it down, and they're right back in this game.
Douglas with 15 points and 16.
81.
It is now a two-point game. Milwaukee's lead, 11 not that long ago, is down to two, 81-79. Lloyd Walton, who spurred the Bucks on earlier with his good, consistent floor play and ability to lead the break, is back in now. Benson comes outside. Here's Winters. Detroit has really tightened up its defense.
Well, we just got the technical for the zone. That was the second. They've had a warning. Bob Kaufman really upset. He says, Earl, it is not a zone. Honest. Earl says, too bad. The Bucks shoot the technical, and they'll get the ball out on the side.
And Big Robert is very unhappy about this turn of events as Brian Winters goes to the free throw line for Milwaukee, an 84% man from the line.
The officials are very aware of the zones now, and they're looking to call quite a bit. Dave Myers back in, John Gianelli out.
Myers hit 9 of his 14 points in the third period. We have 8.5 minutes to go in the game. And Milwaukee holding to a three-point lead after leading by 11 in the third period. So now, 8.5 minutes from the end, unless we go into OT. Myers shoots it up and gets it.
Tough shot. Fading away, put it up on the glass. Now the Bucks, they're not running. That's how they got the lead. The Detroit defense half court too tough. The Bucks are going to have to start running again.
And now Milwaukee doubling up on the ball, making it difficult for Eric Money to get it inside. He gets it to Shoemaker. Here comes M.L. Carr pulling up from the free throw line and knocking it down nicely.
Well, that guy's a player. Can you believe that there were some teams that didn't want him?
He worked awful hard to get in the NBA.
Right. Went to Europe, came back,
played the Eastern League.
Well, he belongs here now, that's for sure. And Kent Benson shows he can shoot the jumper also.
Benson now has six. 86-81 Milwaukee. Leon Douglas goes back over to Carr, moving on Alex English, shooting over him again. Benson off with the rebound. Winners gets it to Alex English, to Lloyd Walton, who loses Eric Money with a fake. But Leon Douglas is there and throws it away. Looks like Lloyd Walton almost made a play in the ball, then he realized, hey, it was my another guy through it. Dave Myers took a whack in the shot.
Sometimes when Lloyd Walton shoots that jump shot, as small as he is and as frail as he is, it looks like it takes everything he's got just to get it up there. Brian Winters not getting many shots today. I think they actually need more shot opportunities out of him. That was a little deep.
Myers took a hard shot in the mouth a little bit earlier. I don't know how. It was in the... He and Shoemaker have been going at each other pretty hard.
Go through. Go shoot!
It is an 86-81 game, Milwaukee. Al Skinner fires a little too much for Detroit. English takes it down as M.L. Carr nicely covers the flank so they don't get the break going. So important, getting out and covering those passing lanes. Myers shoots.
Dave Myers certainly shooting that jumper very nicely. Worked all summer on posting and shooting the jump shot. He says it's helped him tremendously.
Myers could use a little more weight if he can get it.
Look at that.
Eric Money.
He continually goes down and challenges the big guy. Look at that pass. Beautiful play by Brian Winters. Not only can he shoot it, he can pass it. About a week ago in Washington, he had 18 assists.
Milwaukee's lead is backed up to it in 7, 90-83. 6:05 to play. Eric Money is starting to score now. He's got 14 points and starting to come on. Matched up against speed also, and Lloyd Walton, who has the ball. Myers shoots on John Shoemaker. M.L. Carr, lead pass goes up to Money, and Myers works everybody and gets the ball. Look at Lloyd.
Whoa!
Razzle
dazzle.
Now Shoemaker is fouled as he goes to the basket.
Detroit has a little bit to show them also. Here it comes, Lucky Lloyd. Take it behind, do the spin, get the playoff, and Alex English just lay it in.
Lloyd Walton with a spectacular assist. And with 5:27 left to go in the game, it's 92-85, Milwaukee.
Spring. It only comes once a year. If you want a nice, thick lawn, now's the time to do something about it. Give your lawn some Scotts Turf Builder right now. Turf Builder helps grass send off new branches, either tillers or rhizomes. This forms new grass plants that'll thicken up your lawn and fill in those thin spots. But don't wait. Before you know it, spring will be gone.
People joke about businessmen spending a lot of time on the golf course. Well, I'm a golfer who spends a lot of time on business. When I'm traveling, here's how I keep ahead of the paperwork. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary. I can dictate letters, memos, wherever I am. Lanier's Vest Pocket Secretary helps get the work done faster, which leaves more time for what I really like to do. Look for Lanier in the yellow pages under dictating machines.
Outward Bound, Rota, Spain. Local recruiter or call toll-free, It's not just a job. It's an adventure.
Monday.
He has decided to put on your play.
There's some good news with Thelma on Good Time. Then on Baby, I'm Back.
I'm rich. Where did you get that money? Playing the horses?
Ray's in trouble again. Baby, I'm Back, right after Good Times, Monday at 8, 7 Central in Mountain.
With John McLaughlin, this is Don Cricky back at Milwaukee's Mecca. And there is Don Nelson and John Killalay, his assistant. Two gentlemen spent much of their basketball careers with the Boston Celtics organization. Actually, Don Nelson was the best $100 the Celtics ever spent. Started out with the Chicago Zephyrs in the NBA, went to Los Angeles for 2 years. They cut him, and he was picked up for the $100 waiver price by Boston. And he played there for a mere 11 seasons.
Got a few championship rings out of that, didn't he?
Just about as many as he has fingers. Didn't seem to have too many on there today. I think he's waiting to get one here in Milwaukee.
That's right. They've brought a lot of the Boston offense here to Milwaukee also. A lot of the plays that they will run, the Celtics have had for many years.
Boston offense over the years has been go fast and pick up speed. John Shumate at the free throw line. He now has 17 points, a good number of them from the free throw line. It is a 92-87 game with 5 minutes and 20 seconds left to play. Lloyd Walton brings the ball over the timeline against pressure. Now for a report on the Portland-Philadelphia game. We're going to pick up them for a moment to watch us. We welcome our Portland-Philadelphia viewers here at the Mecca in Milwaukee. This is Don Cricky with John McLaughlin. The Milwaukee Bucks, leading by 6 at the half, opened up an 11-point third-period lead. Then Detroit rallied back to within 2, and that's been the story of this game. Milwaukee pulling away, Detroit catching up. Right now it's 92-87, Detroit in red uniforms with the ball.
Detroit doing a fine job defensively, and once again getting inside. Douglas putting it up, getting it back, getting banged. He's been banged around so many times. Not only in the second half, but in the first half, but once again, the Pistons having the ability to get inside on the Bucks.
Big Leon's going to spend some time in the whirlpool. He's been on the deck a good number of times.
See the ball coming into Douglas. He doesn't have a real soft touch around the basket, but that might have something to do with him getting hit all over the arms. Getting the ball back, putting it up again, and now he's on the line.
Junior Bridgman has come off the bench for Milwaukee. The real difference in the game has been the bench scoring of this young Milwaukee team. Bridgman has hit 20 points. Dave Myers came out in the third period. He has 18. English has 13. He is starting for the injured Marcus Johnson, who's not played here today. John Ginelli back in the game now for Milwaukee. 4:45 left to play as Leon Douglas, a consensus All-American of Alabama 2 years ago and the fourth player selected in the NBA draft in the first round by Detroit, filling in for injured Bob Lanier, who will not play again this season. Douglas has 16. Shumate has 18. M.L. Carr has 15. Brian Winner, the best outside shooter on the Milwaukee team, comes off the pick, moves out around it, hits it down to give Milwaukee a 5-point lead.
The Bucks running that set play for Brian Winner is coming off a weak side screen. He is now 5 for 10 in the game, and he will normally get up a lot more shots than that.
Here is ML Carr firing way out of range, a poor percentage shot. The rebound, though, is taken by Shumate. He gets it up and down. It'll be a 3-point attempt now to go to the free throw line. So Detroit stays in. They trail 94-91.
Well, Shumate doing an excellent job of going to the offensive board. I don't really see this foul here. He goes up and he gets it. Now, Alex English standing inside, had his arm up on Shumate's shoulder, and the official caught it. I was wrong the first time.
So if he hits this free throw now, it'll be a 2-point game as Milwaukee running just one game ahead of Golden State for the final playoff spot. With a lot of pressure on, and Detroit, while seemingly out of it, although not mathematically eliminated, the Pistons are playing tough. They beat Portland the other night. They come in here, trailed by 11, and they keep fighting back.
They're doing a good job, the Pistons, of advancing the ball very quickly and getting a shot up without wasting a lot of time and putting it in. On the other end, the Bucks, the Pistons get it back. The Bucks playing a little too cautious.
Bucks, that's right. They've been getting cautious when they've gotten the big lead. They've gotten the lead by running and playing a flat-out running game. Shumate down low. The game plan is Shumate. Missed it all that time. English with the rebound up court. Leon Douglas at 6'10 with a good hand sweeps up the ball, and Detroit has it back and can come to within one now. The field goal here. Carr gets the free shot, and it's a 1-point game, Milwaukee. And this sold-out arena, which comes very much alive when the Bucks hit, is ominously silent now as Detroit is threatening.
Going from one extreme to the other, the turnover's really hurting the Bucks, as you saw in that last situation. Detroit getting it back and scoring.
One and a half minutes to play in the game.
A lot of turnovers in this game, Don, by both clubs all day.
94-93, Milwaukee with a one-point lead. Shot clock is down to one as Winters fires up and can't get it to go. Skinner tips it out to Eric Money. Here he comes on the break. Two men are back for Milwaukee. Ball is tipped away by Walt. Look at the plays by this little backcourt player from Marquette. But he double-handed the ball. Bob Kaufman, the strike coach, was up to protest and he realized the official got it. He quickly scrambled out of the bench because we've had a plethora of technical fouls. Everybody's got me.
Just had three turnovers within about 5 seconds also.
Eric Money trying to put on the dribble show, street-yard basketball, and didn't work it. Myers gets the rebound. 94-93. Milwaukee with the one-point lead as we're inside 3 minutes. 2:45 left to play in the game.
When the Bucks are forced to set up, Don, Detroit defense is outstanding. They're forcing the Bucks out of their offense, and the Bucks have to take a tough shot.
Myers, the UCLA All-American, coming up with big play after big play. He's made spectacular plays at both ends of the floor. Big defensive plays, big offensive plays. Myers has now scored 20 points. Tied for high honors. And it's 96-93, Milwaukee. Shoemate fires.
Well, that's where the Bucks would like to see him shoot from. He says he can shoot from out there, but he missed that one.
Welcome our Cleveland, Chicago viewers who have also joined us now here at Milwaukee. This is Don Quickie with John McLaughlin. Brian Winters fires from about. Myers gets the offensive board. It's awful tough to go back up inside because people are playing football down low in this game. They both need it so badly. Detroit is just about cooked if they don't win this game. And Milwaukee needs all they can get now down the stretch with just 7 games to go after this one.
Nate Myers takes a lot of punishment, limping off right here. We've talked about turnovers. Detroit has 27, Milwaukee with 25 turnovers.
And the Bucks lead by 3.
Monza by Chevrolet, for a car so sporty and so well equipped, it's priced surprisingly low.
If you're planning a business trip, do what more travelers are doing. Call your local Hilton reservation service. We use the unique Hiltron computer, which can tell you lots of things about where you're going, like the fine restaurants at Hilton, major events in town, what teams are playing, the shops right in the hotel. And oh yes, room reservations too. So call Hilton Reservation Service. It's part of Hilton Rainbow Service.
Let the Hilton Rainbow brighten your day.
Yeah, Buck.
I just went to another bar and asked for light beer for Miller.
Yeah.
They said, sorry, Buck, we don't have it.
They didn't have it?
No. I don't want some beer that's gonna fill me up.
No.
I want light. Tastes great.
Right.
Yeah. Has a third less calories than a regular beer.
Yeah.
And man, it's less filling. You think I'm going to the other bar again? No way. From now on, the buck stops here.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Back in Milwaukee, there are the Detroit Pistons down by 3 with 1:54 to go and team fouls.
Very much so. The Milwaukee Bucks with 5 fouls while the Pistons with 2. Let's see if we can pick up on Bob Kaufman in their head.
All we get is the Oregon right now. And again, we welcome our Cleveland, Chicago viewers here at Milwaukee. You see the Bucks in the lead, 96-93, as we come down the stretch. 1:54 left to play. Myers inbounds the ball to Brian Winters. Did not go, and Skinner has the ball, and Detroit can come back to within one.
Now, the Bucks cannot afford to foul. They'll put Detroit on the line because they are in the penalty.
Big hoop by Al Skinner.
Rebound, though, is taken by Shoemate. He gets it up and down. It'll be a three-point attempt now to go to the free throw line. So Detroit stays in. They trail 94-91.
Well, Shoemate doing an excellent job of going to the offensive board. I don't really see this foul here. He goes up and he gets it. Now, Alex English standing inside, had his arm up on Shoemate's shoulder, and the official caught it. I was wrong the first time.
So if he hits this free throw now, it'll be a two-point game as Milwaukee running just one game ahead of Golden State for the final playoff spot. With a lot of pressure on, and Detroit, while seemingly out of it, although not mathematically eliminated, the Pistons are playing tough. They beat Portland the other night. They come in here, trailed by 11, and they keep fighting back.
They're doing a good job, the Pistons, of advancing the ball very quickly and getting his shot up without wasting a lot of time and putting it in. On the other end, the Pistons get it back. The Bucks playing a little too cautious.
That's right. They've been getting cautious when they've gotten the big lead. They've gotten the lead by running and playing a flat-out running game. Shoemate down low. The game plan is Shoemate. Missed it all that time. English with the rebound up court. And Leon Douglas at 6'10 with a good hand sweeps up the ball, and Detroit has it back and can come to within one now. The field goal here. Power gets the free shot, and it's a one-point game, Milwaukee. And this sold-out arena, which comes very much alive when the Bucks hit, is ominously silent now as Detroit is threatening.
Going from one extreme to the other, the turnover is really hurting the Bucks, as you saw in that last situation. Detroit getting it back and scoring.
A half minutes to play in the game.
A lot of turnovers in this game, Don, by both clubs all day.
94-93, Milwaukee with a one-point lead. Shot clock is down to one as Winters fires up and can't get it to go. Skinner tips it out to Eric Money. Here he comes on the break. Two men are back for Milwaukee. Ball is tipped away by Walton. Look at the plays by this little backcourt player from Marquette. But he double-handed the ball. Bob Kaufman, coach, was up to protest, and he realized the official got it. He quickly scrambled out of the bench because we've had a plethora of technical fouls. Everybody's gotten it.
Just had three turnovers within about 5 seconds also.
Eric Money trying to put on a dribble show, street-yard basketball, and didn't work, and Myers gets the rebound. 94-93, Milwaukee with the one-point lead as we're inside 3 minutes. 2:45 left to play in the game.
When the Bucks are forced to set up, Don, Detroit defense is outstanding. They're forcing the Bucks out of their offense, and the Bucks have to take a tough shot.
Myers, the UCLA All-American, coming up with big play after big play. He's made spectacular plays at both ends of the floor. Big defensive plays, big offensive plays. Myers has now scored 20 points. Tied for high honors. And it's 96-93, Milwaukee. Shoemate fires.
Well, that's where the Bucks would like to see him shoot from. He says he can shoot from out there, but he missed that one.
We welcome our Cleveland, Chicago viewers who have also joined us now here at Milwaukee. This is Don Quickie with John McLaughlin. Brian Winters fires for the box. Myers gets the offensive board. It's awful tough to go back up inside because people are playing football down low in this game. They both need it so badly. Detroit is just about cooked if they don't win this game. And Milwaukee needs all they can get now down the stretch with just 7 games to go after this one.
Dave Myers takes a lot of punishment, limping off right here. We've talked about turnovers. Detroit has 27, Milwaukee with 25 turnovers.
And the Bucks lead by 3.
While you're away, George McGinnis hit a couple of field goals for the Philadelphia 76ers. Steve Mix scored 2 free throws, so that adds up now to their 106. You left with the 76ers with 100. Now for the Portland Trail Blazers, Norwood hit a free throw for them, and Tom Owens hit a field goal. Dawkins picked up his 5th foul and took a 20-second injury timeout to tie a shoelace. McGinnis is at the free throw line. For McGinnis, he has scored 21. Irving 23, 9 rebounds. George McGinnis, one of the leading candidates for MVP, and New Jersey beats Washington 118-104. Washington with that 3rd best record in the East. Dawkins strike, and Twardzik picked it off. And Tom Owens comes back with still another. He has scored 24, and he's been the iron man in the middle. McGinnis goes back up. Don't steal that scholarship money, George says. Indiana and I haven't got along all that well since I left school a little early. Owen says I want it back for South Carolina. And he hits outside. Oh, it's 239, 110-94. Dorsey almost had it. Foul before, and they rush in. Owens and Mix. Dvorak a little upset.
We got 13 in a block.
Dvorak still complaining. There will be a timeout. So some cooler heads are going to prevail here on this Sunday afternoon in the Philadelphia Spectrum. Jack McMahon, one of Billy's assistant coaches. And there's the other, Chuck Daly.
See what's new today. When you're driving down the road and you're moving through a curve in your car, something new it is showing lots of nerve. Monza by Chevrolet.
The new Monza by Chevrolet. For a car so sporty and so well equipped, it's priced surprisingly low.
If you're planning a business trip, do what more travelers are doing. Call your local Hilton reservation service. We use the unique Hiltron computer, which can tell you lots of things about where you're going. Like the fine restaurants at Hilton, major events in town, what teams are playing, the shops right in the hotel, and oh yes, room reservations too. So call Hilton reservation service. It's part of Hilton Rainbow Service.
Let the Hilton Rainbow brighten your day.
Yeah, Buck.
I just went to another bar and asked for light beer for Miller.
Yeah. Yeah.
They said, sorry, Buck, we don't have it.
They didn't have it?
No. I don't want some beer that's going to fill me up.
No.
I want light. Tastes great.
Right.
Has a third less calories than a regular beer.
Yeah.
And man, it's less filling. You think I'm going to the other bar again? No way. From now on, the buck stops here.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
Next Saturday at 4 p.m. Eastern, CBS Sports Spectacular presents live the East-West College All-Star Classic from Las Vegas. That's next Saturday at 4 p.m. Eastern on the CBS Sports Spectacular.
And we hope to see Michael Thompson out of Minnesota. Billy Cunningham probably have to defend against him next season. He's sure to be one of the top rookies as the year gets underway. Keith, you and I will be in Las Vegas, seeing all of that top talent. I hear that there are about, half dozen, seven, eight real good prospects, not probably as much overall depth as they had coming into the NBA this year. But there are still enough stars who will help quite a few teams. And here in the Spectrum, Billy Cunningham is shooting for his 23rd consecutive victory here. Done with Dorsey. And Dvorak assessed that personal.
Dvorak pulled Steve Mix's shirt out of the back of his trousers on that play. They had a little confrontation the last time down here before the timeout. And Dave Dvorak obviously didn't forget about it. He tried to get him on a back block there.
Final 2 minutes, and what a week of basketball coming up on CBS. Next Friday, it'll be Los Angeles, Portland from the Forum. McLean misses. McGinnis stays by with it. He may have hurt his left leg. He's all right. Take a pole axe to hurt that big guy, wouldn't it?
Brent, I'd like to add something at this point. You and I have come down pretty hard on the officials on this
you
game.
You and I, right?
Huh? We have.
I take the booze, remember? You take the heat for jumping on the officials, Keith. Go ahead.
I'd just like to say, really, at this point, this has been an extremely, extremely physical game. And these guys are doing one heck of a job out here. These guys are really big, and they are extremely talented.
T.R. Dunn throws in that field goal. Norm Drucker sends over his thanks, Keith. 135. Oh, it's been a tough year. It's a young staff that they've got to work with. Lose a lot of veterans. People like Mindy Rudolph no longer around in the league. Calhoun through the middle. And we got one good game working that we want to go get an update on. Detroit-Milwaukee. So let's go to Don Criqui. A minute to play.
We welcome our Philadelphia-Portland viewers who have joined us. We're in the final minute here at Milwaukee, and the Bucks have a three-point lead, and they just got a very big rebound.
They lead 98-95. Milwaukee in white as Dave Myers goes to the basket and draws the foul. Myers, who has played an inspired game.
Very big defensive effort by the Milwaukee Bucks. If they could hold Detroit as they did, that was important. Now, Winters reading Myers very nicely. The trailer on the break gets inside, gets the foul.
Myers can come pretty close to putting the lid on, although this Detroit team keeps coming back, and certainly he is very much a contender for the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player Award. Myers has scored 20 points. He jump shoots his free throws.
Well, that can certainly hurt a little bit in that particular situation. We talked about Lloyd Walton on that last steal, Don. That was his sixth steal, and he has six assists in the game.
Bridgman and Myers leading Milwaukee with 20 points apiece. English has 13. And now it is a four-point advantage for Milwaukee. 99-95, as you see, in Detroit and Red coming up court quickly with Al Skinner with the ball. Eric Money feeds it back out to Shoemate, back to Money. Way up over the big guys. Did not get it to go, but there's a foul on the play on Ginelli.
Well, that's what we've talked about all day. Eric Money, he goes into the land of the Giants with the big guys, gets the shot off, and draws the foul. Now, you'll see here, Shoemate gives it off to Money on the baseline. He's tough in the baseline. He has actually two people around him, Bridgman behind, Ginelli in front, draws the foul on Ginelli, and he's a pretty good free throw shooter, misses the first. He still has two. Both clubs in the penalty. The Bucks have had five team fouls for some time.
Eric Money, a 6-foot backcourt player from Kettering High School in Detroit, signed as a hardship in the NBA after his sophomore season at Arizona. And he is really matched up against speed, as much as you're going to find. And Lloyd Walton, a little Marquette backcourt player, now in his second year with Milwaukee. Walton has made some superior plays, assisting the big guys underneath as he penetrates.
The Bucks need a score here, Don, because if they don't, there's still time for Detroit to come up and tie it.
Walton dancing all over the floor with the ball, yo-yoing it between hands. Here is Winters firing as the shot clock is just about out. Shoemate has the ball with 12 seconds to go. Money takes it down, up court to Skinner. Detroit has to fire. They need two buckets to tie. 4 seconds. Rebound loose. Skinner picks it up. The basket goes.
They counted it. Skinner picked the ball up, got it in. Earl Strom indicated two.
That was what tied it. That tied it at 99. We'll watch that again.
Eric Money takes the shot here, Don. The ball's loose on the floor, but look at Skinner. Picks it up and just flings it up, and two.
It was out of his hand. So that quick field goal at the final buzzer brings the Detroit Pistons back to an 11-point deficit to where they tie the game. Our Philadelphia and New York viewers be interested to know that George McGinnis was one of the most valuable players in the Philadelphia-Portland game. So we're going to go into overtime here at Milwaukee, John.
Detroit's done a super job today. They've come back, they've hung in there, and they've done an excellent job.
The defense is what's...
All right, we are back as you see our final score here in the Spectrum. Philadelphia 116, Portland 100, and our Chevrolet Most Valuable Player Award goes to George McGinnis. His line, and he beat out a heck of a performance by Tom Owens of the losing Trailblazers. So the Chevrolet $1,000 scholarship will be awarded to Indiana on behalf of Big Mac George McGinnis, who played a whale of a game on this Easter Sunday. Philadelphia slices into Portland's lead in that race for the best record in the NBA and an additional $50,000.
Okay, big green G. If National's gonna be the best car rental company, we have got to hustle. Schultz, the last reservation call.
9 seconds, sir.
Walsh, green light service means?
Fast service, sir.
Willoughby, before we rent this new Chevy,
we check all 10 items on the maintenance checklist.
And then?
We sign it, sir.
Okay, team, let's go.
10,000 people working for you, the big green team.
Willoughby.
We're National Car.
What are more people doing to help their cars last? Protecting them better than ever with Quaker State Motor Oil. Regular use of Quaker State helps avoid expensive engine repairs, helps cars last. Refined from Pennsylvania-grade crude oil, Quaker State helps cars last. Maybe that's why Quaker State's the best-selling motor oil in America. Quaker State helps cars last.
Why are men switching from aerosol hairsprays to Vitalis Super Hold Pump Spray?
The pump? Because it doesn't spray any aerosol propellants.
The pump? Well, it costs less to use. Save money.
Because the pump is stronger. Can hold longer than the best-selling aerosol.
The pump. Vitalis Super Hold Pump Spray. Now with an even finer spray. Why don't you switch from your aerosol to...
The pump. Do-do-do. The pump.
We're back. 116-100. Philadelphia beats Portland. So on the year, the Sixers go 52-21. Portland 55-19. Two games separate those two teams for the best record in the NBA. The 76ers face nine more games. The Blazers will play eight. Their next contest, the 76ers go against Buffalo. The Blazers will take on Boston. Rest of the schedule, Philly, Atlanta, Houston, San Antonio, New Orleans, Detroit, Indiana, Washington twice. Boston, Phoenix, L.A., Seattle, Houston, Golden State, Denver, and L.A. For the Blazers, let's go to Detroit, Milwaukee, and overtime. Here's Don Criqui.
We welcome the people who have just joined us to watch the 76ers and the Trailblazers here at Milwaukee. This is Don Criqui with John McLaughlin. We are heading into overtime. As you see at the end of regulation, Detroit rallying back from 11 points down in the third period to tie the game at 99. And now we start the overtime as Detroit controls with possession. ML Carr has the ball. Chicago losing to Cleveland today, 95-78. John Shumate gives Detroit the lead in the overtime.
Detroit seems to have the momentum. They've hung in there all day, and John Shumate that time going outside. That's where the Bucks would like to push him, but he showed them that he can shoot out there.
Official Hugh Evans on top of the play, and he catches John Shumate hacking at the ball.
Here's what put it in overtime. Eric Money throwing up a tough shot. It comes off. No one can get a handle on it. Alvin Skinner picks it up, flips it in, and ties the score.
Just releasing the ball before the clock was out. So now Detroit has come back, and I believe this is the first time in the game they've led. 101-9. Now we're tied up. John Ginelli hits it. So it's 101-101 in overtime. 4:15 to play in it.
Well, it's important to mention again, they've been very good this year in overtime. 7-1. That's very unusual for a young club, and I'm sure they'll want to make it 8.
We'll be going right to the Sea Pines Heritage Golf Classic in South Carolina at the conclusion of this game. But we'll first wrap it up here in Milwaukee as the Bucks, needing every win they can get to make that final playoff spot of the West. Now are locked up 101-101 with Detroit, playing without its best player, Bob Lanier, who is out with knee surgery.
Skinner has come in the game and done an excellent job of helping this Detroit team, not only offensively with putting the ball in, but also his very good defense.
Eric Money gets a clear side, trying to work one-on-one with Walton. Tips it off to Alvin Skinner, who hit the gamer that tied it up and sent it into overtime. And here comes Walton. Watch him go on the break. Lead to Brian Winters. Milwaukee comes back to take the lead.
Well, that's what the Bucks need to win. They have to run. They have to get out. And on the other end, Detroit must be aware of that and convert from offense to defense.
Winners, Milwaukee's leading scorer at over 20 points a game, has the 14 in this game. That is John Shumate coming back to tie the game.
The Pistons continually getting inside on the Bucks with the big guys. You get Douglas and Shumate inside, it's going to be something.
We're down to 3:20 to go in the overtime. Myers is setting down low. Ginelli loses the ball to Skinner. This guy's come off the bench, and he's the reason there is an overtime. He hit that desperation shot as the clock ran out for Detroit. Money back to Skinner. And Detroit's going to call a play and set it. They have Douglas posted low. Shumate comes out high. They're trying to get it into Douglas in the middle. ML Carr comes out from behind him. Dave Myers takes a shot in the eye, but he gets the ball.
It's been a physical game all day. Dave Myers just caught a little bit of an elbow from Douglas there, and the Milwaukee fans felt like it should have been a call.
Myers has taken a few shots, but he stayed right in there. Here he fires it up. Invariably, when he's been hit or knocked down, he comes back and throws up something from 20 feet.
The Pistons switching on everything. They're trying to push the Bucks outside. They're not allowing the Bucks the jump shot. Therefore, you'll have big guys on guards. They don't seem to worry about that.
Myers has 23 points in the game. It is 105 to 103. Milwaukee and White holding the 2-point lead on their home floor. Money gets a free shot. And Money locks it at 105.
John Shumate just grabbed Lloyd Walton by the leg that time and held him away from Money as he puts the ball in. You can get away with it.
Watch and shoot.
Ryan Winters working down low, and as he comes back, we're going to have a foul call.
Foul on John Gianelli for trying to set the screen for Brian Winters. The Bucks not executing sharply or crisply when they come up and have a half-court situation.
We have a timeout on the floor right now. The Heritage Golf Classic is next when we conclude here at Milwaukee with 1:58 to play in overtime. It's tied at 105-105.
Port of call, South Pacific.
Liberty call, Liberty call.
The Navy. See a recruiter or call toll free. It's not just a job, it's an adventure.
Wherever you may roam, you'll find our name is known.
You can trust Delco.
Thanks, Delco.
Delco Freedom Battery.
I trust Delco batteries. And my reputation rides on Delco shock absorbers. Because you never know when you're going to need Delco's smooth control.
When the road is curved and rough, you need the shock that's tough.
You can trust Delco.
Thanks, Delco.
Delco shocks and batteries. Delco shocks and batteries.
Thanks, Delco.
Maybe your hair's back there, huh?
1:58 left to play in overtime. The Detroit Pistons huddling with their head coach, Bob Kaufman.
Leon will be getting the pick coming up here. Shoe flare. If you can't hit Leon flaring, well, then you know the guard may be open.
When you say flare, you mean in the middle, right?
In the middle, yeah, in the middle.
Bob Kaufman trying to set the offensive strategy here. I couldn't really make it out completely. I know that they're concerned about going to Shoemate on the weak side if something breaks down. So let's see what happens.
The name of this game is Shoot and Don't Miss. The other guys don't likely do right now. They're both hot, 105-105 in overtime. 1:58 left to play. Milwaukee coming into the game with a record of 39-35, running second to Denver in the Midwest Division. The Golden State closing fast after that win over New York last night. Money on the drive. Shoemate with the offensive board into Myers. No foul. When two guys collide, that's got to be a foul one way or the other. We get one.
Well, you see the value of offensive rebounds. The Pistons getting too many opportunities at the basket. Shoemate gets this one. Goes up, no foul. They get it back. Douglas inside. Either Benson or Winters fouls him, and he's going to go to the line. You cannot allow that many offensive rebounds.
At the line. Shooting two.
So big Leon Douglas goes to the free throw line. Now in his second year from Alabama, he's only a 63% free throw shooter. So far in this game, Leon Douglas has scored 18 points, and he is the Iceman up there right now.
You can see Douglas taking his time up there. His coach, Bob Kaufman, has said, take a lot of time, steady it down, and right now we're having a little change under the basket. The Detroit players work on one side or the other, so the Bucks players say, I'm going with you. Vincent's supposed to line up, obviously, with John Shoemate.
Detroit has gone the distance today, as they will the rest of the season, without their best player, Bob Lanier, who is out with following knee surgery Friday that was very successful, and he can't play again this year, this season. And Milwaukee has not had the services of the great rookie, Marcus Johnson, who has a shoulder injury. He's in uniform, but has not played. 107 to 105, Detroit with a two-point lead. Benson gets the basket down. Kent Benson, who led Indiana University to a national championship a couple of years ago.
Benson lost the ball here. It actually goes in. The Bucks trying to run a little pick and roll. There's a switch. The Bucks swing it to the top. Benson gets in. Now watch. It slips right out of his hand. He gets fouled, and it goes in. Whew. That's the kind you walk away from and act like, oh, I knew it was going in all the time.
Well, Benson can break the tie, and he does. 108 to 107, but we still have a lot of time left in overtime. We have 1:30 left to play. Eric Money calls the signals. ML Carr comes out high. Skinner goes down low. He's been tough. Winter steals the ball. But Wisely does not gun it down court. Detroit does a very good job cutting off the passing lanes.
Very nice anticipation by Brian Winters, and you are right, Don. Detroit really playing the passing lanes in the second half and forcing the Bucks outside.
Dave Myers out hustles Douglas. Foul on Douglas.
Almost a turnover again for the Milwaukee Bucks. Douglas going after the ball. Myers dumping on it, and they call the foul on Leon Douglas. Here you see him lose it. Now watch Douglas go up. You have body contact. That's a hard one to call. Myers came into Douglas just as much as Douglas came into Myers.
Next Friday night at 11:30 Eastern time, you'll see live on CBS the Portland Trail Blazers and the red-hot Los Angeles Lakers meet at Los Angeles. Immediately following this game, we'll be switching to South Carolina for final round coverage of the Sea Pine Heritage Golf Classic. Myers at the free throw line. 24 points for Dave Myers. He's the top producer in the ballgame.
He also has 10 rebounds, but on the other side, Detroit Shoemate has 14, Leon Douglas 15.
15 and 14 rebounds.
That's right.
Dave Myers gets him down when they count. Now it's 110 to 107. 1 minute to go in overtime, but Detroit down time and again in this game has invariably rallied back. They didn't go ahead until they finally got into overtime. The best they could do was gain a tie in the final shot of the game of regulation. Here is Skinner shooting. Big rebound. Bridgman loses it out of bounds, though. He collided with his own man, Dave Myers. The ball will come in bounds to Detroit. John?
The Bucks really tightening up the D that time. And what they tried to do is double team on the ball as much as possible. They did an excellent job of it, not allowing it to get inside. Skinner put the ball up. Junior had the rebound, but knocked out of bounds by Dave Myers.
Into Skinner. 44 seconds to play in the overtime. 44 to go. 3-point lead for Milwaukee. As Money has no shot inside against Myers, now he throws up an air ball. Benson takes down the defensive board, and Brian Winters, the all-star guard out of South Carolina, settles things down now as they open up a professional version of the four corners, but that shot clock is winding down to 10. The game clock is down to 20, as you see. Lloyd Walton, the dancer, is out there, weaving his way through Detroit. Shot clock is down to 2. Bridgman shoots, 11 seconds to go. Now Detroit has to hurry down court. Detroit down by 3. 5 seconds to play. Money gets it over to Douglas. They let him score. 1-point game. And there is the horn, and Milwaukee wins it. Our most valuable player, our Chevrolet Most Valuable Player Award goes to Dave Myers, and the $1,000 scholarship will be awarded to UCLA on behalf of Dave Myers. Don't forget, the Sea Pines Heritage Golf Classic is coming up next. The final score here at Milwaukee, the Bucks 110, Detroit 109 in overtime. For John McLaughlin, this is Don Crickey. The NBA on CBS is a presentation of CBS Sports.
This is CBS.
Hale Irwin won his first two tournaments here. And you just saw the defending champ, Graham Marsh. He won his first tournament here last year. Can Larry Nelson hold on?